Is there any?
Yeah, Jody's here. She's here. I don't know if she knows. She's here.
Can I grab a piece of paper?
Hi, Mike.
Hello.
Hi, Mike. I'm showing up for a phone. Did you find it?
She's lost her phone.
I almost went in my glasses.
Almost?
Almost. I might be able to get away with it for a while.
I'm pretty close.
The data connection is the loose link or the.
Is it Wi-Fi capable or not? You have to be physically connected.
You have to be physically connected.
It's in my pocket.
When I went back home for the papers.
They're making the bigger one.
This is how it came in the package. Flatlight, it's like, what the hell is that?
Right.
But it's higher than I thought it would have actually.
Yeah.
She has one from Duncan that got all the way up.
Yeah, they're going to be making another one to fit the 32 inch cup.
Okay, board, I'm going to call this meeting to order on Saturday, October 28th, number 4. There are a couple of very short items on a business agenda for the board to discuss, and then we'll go right into the budget workshop. So that's why I officially called this to order.
Okay.
So one is the town copier.
Yep.
So we have checked in with two departments.
Yep.
With regard to whether or not they can use the copier.
Yep.
Is the board good with trying to find the best place for their copier, where it does the most good?
Yes, but didn't the fire department respond first that they needed it? That's how I thought we were just handling it. Whoever responded first gets it. But
we did the board discuss that and decide that?
Just in my mind, but we were talking about it. It could have been. So I don't remember if we did or not.
Here's how I look at it. I believe it's the board's responsibility to deploy our assets in the best way possible. I don't really know who has the oldest copy or who has the copy that's most vulnerable,
yeah.
But I feel that the printer should go to wherever it's needed the most.
Well, the fire department has to make sure other copies of the MSDs, and every company in town is supposed to have an MSD book on file with them. And so they're working on just kind of like what something Caroline has right now.
When you say MSD,
you have to keep track of all your chemicals in your building, like the soap on the counter.
Right.
And
do we know that their printer is vulnerable? But are you aware of that?
He says it was quite old, and when I was there, it was a tiny little thing like Caroline's. But
does the board
this one's vulnerable too.
Does the board object to our finding the status of these copiers?
I don't. It doesn't matter. Sure.
Okay, so we'll continue with that.
Obviously, wherever's going to do the most good, it makes the most sense.
Okay, so let's get
easier
we'll gather more data.
Probably first gets it, but.
Okay, I'm gonna.
We didn't ask them. We didn't ask them first. We didn't ask them at the same time.
Didn't
so
send an email to the same two people at the same time?
No, we did not. We checked with the fire. And then we didn't hear from them. And then somebody said, oh, what about the libraries? Oh, my God, of course.
Oh, I thought the email went out at the same time to both people.
No.
Never mind. I thought that's what happened.
No, and even so, it's still our responsibility to make sure that the printer is going to the spot where it's going to do the most good. I don't know what that is at this moment, but we're not, I just don't think we're playing a play art game. I mean, it's not.
Okay, well, then I need you to send out that email because you left it in my hands. And then I said, fine, Chief, you responded first, you get it.
He responded back, he said he's good for whatever happens, right?
I didn't check since yesterday.
I thought you sent it to both of us, same time, Jody. I apologize. I didn't really look to see who was sent to when I saw the email. CC or
so. If I added the confusion, I'm sorry, but you really need to put this printer where it's going to do the most.
Sure. I don't think any of us would argue with that.
Okay. And I don't know that we know the answer to that just yet.
I'm not going to go to war for use printer to anybody. Whoever needs it needs it. It's not really. That's not the.
So. So now the confusion is around the Veterans Day holiday.
Yeah, I don't.
So I guess the question is when is the holiday? Is
so
it?
It's Friday, right?
The federal holiday was recognized on Friday.
Yeah.
So our personnel policy says that when the holiday falls on a Saturday, we're closed on the following
Monday.
When
the official holiday falls on a Saturday, right?
I'm not sure that it says that.
No.
That's my interpretation. So the question is, So, the question is, do we want to advise the front office that that we're going to be closed on Friday and open on Monday, knowing that the town clerk is going to be able to set her own time?
Yeah. It's strange. I mean, the past, didn't the federal government always have, typically follow that if a holiday happened on a weekend, it always went to the following Monday.
Well,
isn't that why we're doing it? Most towns do that and states do that?
Yes, it didn't do us any favors this year.
It's crazy. Yeah.
My suggestion.
Well, the first holiday, though, I feel like this year.
Well, no, it happened to something happened
yeah.
to us last year.
I mean, whatever. I mean, Friday's just a good Monday.
My overall recommendation is that in January, we take a look at the calendar and publish when the town is going to be managing these holidays so that there's no confusion.
Exactly.
So I've got that on the agenda for us to kind of review.
Worry about
that. The question is,
year, yeah.
I don't know, do you want to come down and say the town hall is closed on Friday? I mean, the town hall is closed on, wait a minute.
The town hall is closed
on Friday.
Closed on Friday, open on Monday. Now, we've already done the transfer station is open on Saturday per our action. We've done
closed,
that already.
Though, on
and closed on Monday,
Monday
per our action.
So will people be confused then that the town hall is open and the transfer station is closed? I don't know.
I have no
is it
idea.
Better be consistent that everything is closed on the same day? I don't care either way. But
because the transfer station would have been closed on Saturday.
Right.
Right.
So, because that's the actual holiday.
That's the confusion.
Yeah.
Right.
That's the part of the confusion.
Yeah.
So, I am told, I don't like to use the passive voice, Caroline has told me, but I don't know how she was told, Caroline has told me that the front office plans to be closed on Monday. The transfer station is closed on Monday. So
okay.
We can go along with that and publicize it that way, or say, look, I mean, I don't know that it...
And Friday is a slower day for town hall anyway, correct? I can't answer that, can I?
Well, they're planning on closing on Monday.
They gotta be here on Friday to work?
Yes.
So they need our action for this? Because the federal holiday falls on Friday.
Right.
All the schools are off on Friday.
Post office will be closed on Friday. Everything. Banks. But it will be confusing. It's going to be confusing either way. If we're closed on Friday, people will be confused.
Either way, the issue is confusing,
right.
Which is why I've got on the agenda for us to, in January, just make a year's schedule.
Yeah.
So
well,
that
we will.
Maybe
pardon?
Before. When does it need to
be? We can say we're open on Friday for your convenience because you're going to have a day off.
That's true, too. And we could do that. People are just so used to the Monday following a weekend holiday always being closed. I mean, not just here, everywhere.
So at least this would say that Monday we're closed.
Right.
Town hall will be closed, the transfer station will be closed, and Friday will be open.
But the board's meeting.
Well, we're meeting.
Yes. We're meeting, though, right?
We're
so
meeting,
yeah, we have to.
Yeah,
we have too much to do.
We have
so.
Too much to do. Are we good with that?
We're going to have to be, I think.
Yeah.
I
And forgive me for not knowing this, but I know Caroline said she sent it out to the email. Did it make it to the email?
To what?
That the transfer station was closed.
Oh, yes, I got an email about it, I think.
Okay.
Wow, let me back up.
I put it on Facebook.
I also thought we had a conversation. On thanks, let me walk, go on.
I'm glad I'm not the only one.
That kid, we got things, you know, other things we worry about, right? So.
Well, we have to worry about costumes this weekend. Right?
I know. Well, Elizabeth doesn't worry about myself, not Caroline.
All right, so here's what I have. Friday, the town hall is open. Saturday, the transfer station is open. We already have that, so I will put that. And Monday, town hall is closed. The transfer station is closed, but we're meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Is that, are we good with that? Oh, absolutely. And I have it on the agenda for us to review the notion of having a, so that we can look at the calendar ahead of time and see if there are any issues like this coming up, and then publish it to the to our various department heads to make sure that there are not any particular issues for that year.
I don't know if we did get a, maybe made it on to...
I put it on Rollins but Happenings.
Any other business?
And I emailed the lady that was concerned the last time directly.
Oh, that's good.
So, and she was very happy.
Good.
Any other business to attend
well,
to?
Well, I didn't get the emails. We need to make sure it gets sent out.
I will do that.
Caroline said she sent it, but I don't know.
This is an overall what's happening.
Yeah, and then do we want to address the PTO posting on town website?
Oh, yeah. It's on the agenda for the 6th.
Oh, for Monday, they will wait.
Well, they needed it before that because the event is on the 6th, I believe.
So, all right. So what is the I guess I don't know the issue. I know the overall issue.
So the PTO, I guess the PTO wanted to put something on the town website. Tia wasn't sure if it was allowed to go on the town website because the PTO is not town. So, but neither is
our run thing, right? Or ours, sure. All those things, right?
When Tia called me, I said, well, I'll put it on the agenda, because, you know, we'll review.
Right.
She said that there had been several postings for PTO activities. And so...
A request, you mean?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes. And so she just... Because these things are pushed out, you know, that's what we need to be careful about. They're not just, like, listed there, and if you want to, you can go online, you can look. They're pushed out to people who want to take the email. So if our email notices about road closings, about meeting changes for the planning board, for the select board, for public hearings, are coming in with a lot of other stuff.
You need to be a little more.
You know what happens?
Though.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it was. I thought maybe it was time to review. One of the things that I thought I would. One of the things that we could consider, if it could happen, is that we can separate them. So people can sign up for one sort of thing, like the town stuff, and community things.
That's something that Tia can manage?
I don't know.
Yeah.
That I don't know that, but I thought that would be a
or
good first step. What do you think about that?
Yeah, because then you'd have to take ARC off of that, and you'd have to take all the other
the garden
things.
Club, the
yeah,
duck
yeah.
race,
yeah.
You know, all of that stuff.
That's true.
So, or limit it to one a month, or one a quarter, or something like that. But
yeah,
my first choice would be, can we separate them?
That's a TFN.
Yeah.
Well,
we have been sending them out, though, right? Because we have the things that Arch sends things up, the duck race, I forgot about that.
Yep.
So, I mean, just
I think
it feels kind of weird to say that.
Tia,
you can't do it, though.
I think she just, there have been a few things.
They had a lot more about it.
Yeah, because I miss, like, they had a daddy-daughter donut day or something last
really?
Year.
Oh, last year.
And I'm like, oh, God, and Zoe would have loved that.
Yeah.
Because I think it was her Valentine's Day or something.
The community, yeah. I will say this, as the parent of a child in the school now, the communication directly from the school is a little lacking at times, most of the time. So, whatever we can do to help folks, but not everyone has a kid in the school, but then there are folks that have school-age kids that don't attend the school, they're still eligible to go to those things, so.
Right.
But yeah, I think the opt-in is a good idea, actually.
The sports programs.
Yeah, all
that
stuff. Yeah.
Like,
well, right now, people can only opt in
right.
for everything. It's
right.
I mean, you opt in for nothing or for everything. And so the question is, are we overloading?
Yes. The other side of the coin is that I guess it's my responsibility as a parent to sign up. Because the PTO, okay, I have not been to a meeting, but you can sign up, I guess they're gonna start, if they haven't already, they're going to start, let's see if it was on the other night, the historical preview. They're gonna have a list of, they're gonna start emailing to, so like, we can sign up for that, or we probably should, as parents. So there's that too, you know, parents have to be proactive, I have not, we'll admit that.
But some of their fundraisers are probably of general usefulness, right?
There's that too.
The penny sale in March, you want.
How many grandparents would not have loved to take the kids to the corn maze?
That corn maze thing, yeah, exactly, yeah.
My mother would have been all over that.
And she's not gonna sign up for that list either.
Right.
Most grandparents.
She's not in town.
So I would prefer, my first thought is, well, let's just separate them, you know, in that way.
If we can do that, I'm all for that.
Okay, so I'll check with Tina.
But if we can.
We should figure out, can we do let other groups do it, and it has been useful to have other groups do it.
We can talk about having a, you know, so much a month, or so much, one a month, one.
You might not wanna participate in the road race, I'm not running any road races, but I wanna know when it's happening, so I know where to avoid driving too, right? I mean, no, seriously, I don't wanna go down.
Yeah.
So it is still useful.
Well, that could be a general notice though, from the police, right, from the next.
Could be, yeah, it could be, yeah. I know there was a lot of concern at our meeting the other night that had nothing to do with that, this topic. But
I just think it would help them raise more money too.
Probably would. It's a valid point, we're letting other groups in town do it. But if they're sending out 6 or 7 a month, and that's not gonna happen either, we're gonna find the struggle sweet spot, right?
Well, I mean, it's really simple if we can just have people sign up for one versus the other, then.
Yeah.
Or both.
But there are folks in town that will say, oh, I don't have any desire to participate in it. Why are you clogging my inbox? So,
yeah. Do we have any other general business to discuss, board business? Are we ready to, sorry.
No, let's dive in.
Are we ready to adjourn then?
I think so.
Okay, go into the workshop. Spell it later. It's completely wrong.
We're German 919.
It is RN. Yes, that's the one I want to get right. Okay. So now let's go on to the order of business, which is our budget. So let's start with the big picture. And I've had to sort of, you know, I was working on this thing as recently as this morning. I mean, things are coming in really late this year. I'm not sure why, but they're coming in really late. So, but for us, the board, I'd like to start with the big picture of where we are. And this is, you know, I haven't been able to tie everything in. You know, there could be some things off here and there, but this is generally, I think, where we are. And that is, 2017. So with proposed expense appropriation and anticipated revenues, they're both going down because of the funding issue, that right now we're standing at 105,000, almost 106,000, I guess, in additional property taxes. It's hard to know exactly what the impact on the tax rate is. This is based on, you know, I don't know what this year's tax rate is. So now,
so for this year,
this is right now.
In what we're living.
Right now.
Okay.
Yes. So I would like to see us reduce this.
Yeah.
We're on the revenue side, and I don't necessarily want to spend too much time on revenue right now. I want to go directly to expense, I think. Well, we've got a $110,000 grant that's showing up here, which is a one-time grant. This is the dairy grant. All and
right.
So we don't want that to cover a multitude of sins that we're just going to have to pay for the following year.
Exactly.
So I reduced our draw on fund balance from 200 to 100
okay.
to kind of equalize that.
Okay.
And therefore, here we are at this. Okay.
That still leaves us with 105?
Wait. Needing to raise 105,000.
Yes.
Wait, instead of pulling two, you pulled one, or you pulled
yes.
another one?
No, instead of pulling two,
okay.
100,000, I'm pulling 100,000.
And
because we're getting this one-time gift of the
good.
Okay. $110,000 grant. So, you know, you want to have the budget
yeah.
In order to help with projections in the future.
Exactly.
So, So that's where we stand. I really would like to see this down. I think there are places where we have the opportunity to do it, whether it can happen or not, I don't know, but there are places that have the opportunity. So we can come back to this later.
Are you gonna show it?
Yeah, let's go to the expense, is that...
Are you gonna show us those opportunities? Are you gonna show us today those opportunities?
I can tell you, I think the opportunities are the transfer station and the highway department, only because there were just a lot of lines that we just kind of went up with.
Okay.
You know, that were non-salary related lines.
Okay.
And I'm not sure that we have looked carefully on at the part-time stuff that we might be able to reduce because of that.
Okay.
So that could be an opportunity. The other one is the CIP.
Okay.
You know, we don't have final figures, and when we get there, I would say the paving projects for the fire department. What I would like, the challenge I would like to see is to reduce the pressure in both the 2018 and the 2019.
Yeah.
And if we could move those paving projects somewhere in the future, which they were originally,
mm-hmm.
and we don't even know, I doubt that the price on either of those is correct. So if there are other ways to reduce the pressure from the CIP, that would be fine as well.
Has George responded as to whether or not he'll be able to come up with estimates?
We asked him.
I didn't know if you heard about it.
No,
yes, you were.
He said he'd work on it.
Okay, all right. Yeah. Well, we've heard then. Okay.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah, but not, you don't have...
No, that's fine. He's coming on Thursday night, maybe next Thursday, coming
okay.
up.
So, unless you want to do this differently, we can just go right to the expense. Okay. Some changes are this line, finance and admin.
Yeah.
We have now a full year of 32 hours a week.
Okay.
So that affects the payroll and the retirement system. Other changes. Printing, copying. You know, we can see if you want to do a smaller annual report that just covers the what we're required to do from a printed copy point of view. So that may
yeah.
be a possibility.
Are we? We should consult. I think I said it before, but maybe not. We should consult with Kate to see what's actually required.
She knows. No, she knows. She's got the whatever it is, the RSAs.
Yeah.
So,
we
know.
Actually, printing more than we would need to. I bet it would surprise me.
Well, every year it gets a little more expensive, and you know, there's usually stuff left over. So,
mm-hmm.
yeah, it's one spot where maybe we can reduce this. Maybe not. It's
yeah.
not a huge thing. So.
Right. Okay.
So, let's see. So in the IT line, so we've got Google Apps, 3,000 of computer support, 2,600 for Comcast. These are this is MapGeo.
Yeah.
And then miscellaneous.
Yeah.
You know, the UPS, we've talked about getting them for the first four workstations.
Yeah.
That sort of thing. So that's that. Professional services has an overall decline,
mm-hmm.
and if we see what we're building in professional services, well, peer review is back again. We haven't done it yet. This is a permanent MOA, not just a winter time, but one that covers road maintenance.
Yeah.
So it probably is not 3,000. I'm not sure. I don't know. But it involves Dover, so there could be a lot of back and forth
right.
trying to get something organized. Compliance, this is our favorite compliance issues.
yeah.
We've talked about having Steve work on renegotiating the cell tower lease.
Yeah.
It would be an offsetting revenue amount if he were successful. This is for any miscellaneous for hydro relicensing.
Mm-hmm.
And then just the general purpose stuff that comes up. Engineering, you know, we can look at this as just one combined thing, but, you know, just any general purpose thing or Sligo Road or, you know, if we want him to look, if we want some help in planning out what needs to be done from a stormwater point of view in the village,
yeah.
with drainage, et cetera, et cetera.
Yeah.
There was another engineering thing that I thought, this came to me when I was looking at the CIP this morning. it is really frustrating to look at the $168,000 that we have for the old mill lane bridge.
Yeah.
That services two pieces of property.
Yep.
Two. And so, I don't know why we can't just continue to replace the bridge with a temporary one. Well, right now we have a in other words, instead of building for however many hundreds of dollars, thousands of dollars,
right.
a bridge that has a, let's say, a 75-year lifespan,
right.
if we would just spend a tenth, 15% on these temporary bridges, like what we laid down right now. But somehow we're still, that bridge is still red-listed, so there may be other things. So one thing we might consider doing with some of these dollars is asking...
I think it's still red-listed because a temporary bridge is not a long-term solution.
Right, and it's a two-lane road.
Yeah,
and with the turn on Sligo, with that turn...
This is the old mill lane bridge.
Well, either one, but...
This one is no turn.
Well, if you even go on old mill lane, it's so narrow the trucks can't get through the plowing. Remember, it got hit?
It did get damaged last year, the year before last year. Got bent a bit, I think.
It's so narrow that the truck that needs to get through there can't get through there.
I have to send another one down. So, I mean, but there, I mean.
So, eventually, these bridges, even though they only house two houses, someday they may supply more.
Yeah.
We don't know that.
Because that road, it's Fresh Creek Road. Fresh Creek Road goes.
Does it go to that end?
Well, all the way. It goes to Dover, over to.
Wait, but if that became,
over to Bear Road.
But if that became developed, wouldn't we want to have people then come from that, access it from that way?
We can't tell them how to access it.
Well
the plan.
Actually, you could close that. You could close the bridge off and make them go. I'm suggesting more than you could.
Well. I'm fine, you know, we don't have to make that decision, but anyway, this
we're
is...
We're talking about imaginary. Which,
right. So, I'm just saying some opportunities for using some general engineering, assistance. That's
okay,
all.
That's fine.
So, all right, so that's where that comes from, $23,000.
I'd rather just keep putting money into the culvert or the bridge fund for now, because it's on that list.
We are, it's on the CIP.
Right.
With a lot of money. Almost 170,000. Mm-hmm. That's just the 20% of it.
Right.
So we're paying for it in other ways. We're all paying for the other 80%.
Right.
That, you know, for again two houses.
Well, the larger discussion, and I think before the planning board, then potentially the ZBA and the select board, is to allow construction in situations like that, so we don't get into this problem again. So that's more of a longer term discussion, but nothing you can do about it now.
Right. This is just
the sort of have access to fire, police.
I'm just kind of putting that out there that we've got a lot of money in the CIP for this bridge replacement. That's
probably wasn't the best idea to allow building back there, but it happened. So
it was
a long time ago. So it's
and it was probably a wooden bridge.
It probably was. Yeah. And there were no there was no EPA, there was
right.
no EDF, where you could just do whatever you wanted. And that's not necessarily the best thing in the world either, but still, I mean.
So here's reimbursable expenses. We didn't have enough to manage accidents and stuff, so we've upped it to 14,000. There's an amount of a similar scope on the revenue side, so it's, I should put it green, so it doesn't have any impact on taxation. Short-term interest is still here. I don't know that it needs to be, but it's probably best to have some kind of line there just in case. And here's our contingency, which is always 1% of the prior year's operating expenses. Elections and registrations, of course we have three elections this year instead of one. So all those election-related lines have had an increase. There's also a line to take care of a reporting secretary and child care for town meeting, which we didn't really have lines for last year. And Kate requested another voting booth for $700. I think everything else is pretty much the same. Actually. I think this gets reduced to zero because I have to get back to Caroline with this. I think she told me something on the fly that I'm only now remembering, and that is that we paid 2 years' worth. InfoSystems.
Okay.
Town clerk info, I don't know.
There's something else, I can see there's something else under there.
Wait a minute.
It's okay.
Town clerk InfoSystems.
Okay.
That's what
I can see there was something underneath it. There we go.
Yeah, so you can barely see it.
Yeah, okay.
I'm going to highlight that because I think because of the calendar, we ended up paying, so we actually are paid until June of 2019. So we might be able to reduce this.
Okay.
I'll highlight that
and
check on it. Financial administration, the only change is an increase in the audit because his prices, you know, have slowly crept up and we need to cover both the regular audit and the possibility of audits during the year if an auditable person leaves, like Caroline or tax collector or the town clerk, and maybe others, the treasurer maybe, I don't know.
Yeah.
So the revaluation lines, these are avatars. We haven't received their increase yet, so I used 5%.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's sufficient, but that's where that is. Health insurance. So we talked about gathering up all the health insurance and
put it under one line.
There was an overall 6% decrease in health insurance premiums, but we had to add, and I chose to add a family coverage for an expected highway department employee. Just, you know, we don't have any fluff in there. So if, you know, if a single becomes a two-person or a single becomes a family or two-person becomes a family, we have to cover it, and there isn't any buffer in there at the moment.
Did you want to put in your notes that there is a 6% decrease for what you have to present?
I think it's 6.1.
Because not many people got a decrease.
Okay. So I think this is okay, but we need to review it. We need to add one more, and I think I probably did, but we need to make sure that Caroline's is okay. So it's not going to increase by much. This is pretty, it's not a big figure anyway. So, but I want to make sure that we've got things lined up there correctly.
And our life and disability is Mass Mutual, you said, right?
Boston. We increased the employee safety. The training line, we've moved down here, we talked about that.
And combined, right?
Yes, except for fire and
police.
The training would come from there. Background checks, I mean, this may still need more. The following year, we'll see again how it's used for the summer rec.
Mm-hmm.
But we did double it to take care of that. Unemployment's down. This comp is up a little bit.
Well, I think we put background checks in the summer rec budget. But that's okay.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's, you know, I think I did see them. Oh, good. All right. So we may still.
But that doesn't mean that your road agent and.
Exactly. Your transfer station. The turnover. Exactly. Because they're about. You know, I think $50-$60 a pop, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You're skipping all the way down to.
Please just stop. Do exactly what you just did and stop. So, yes, because that's how I built it based on last year and we didn't do it. Would you like to say something?
I'd still like to do it.
Do you know how much it cost?
Well, last year it was $5,000.
That wasn't, what we determined is that there wasn't enough interest in the single only. Right, I believe that's what happened. People wanted either give me the whole family or I'm not interested.
Because there was enough other employees they could get it through their other spouses and their government for the family.
But we just added a new full-time employee road agent. That may, because the numbers were like 7.5 or something like that.
If you would like to do some homework.
So.
You know, prices are not, we can't, we don't know that they're the same as last year. We would need to do some checking in, I think, because it would make a significant difference in our swing one way or the other, so. But that's where it is. You know, we should probably.
It's an important benefit to offer, so. The better your benefit package, the more, the increased volume of well-qualified employees may apply for positions in office, so. Could have a benefit to the town, not just the employee having a, you know, the benefit of dental services.
I don't deny that.
No, I know, I'm just.
You always have to make decisions,
so if we can find something that's reasonable.
And we can justify it based on, you know, the rest of the budget.
Make some adjustment elsewhere. We're going to still think about $105,000, so we need to find someone here, right? So, $105,000, in fact, you want to find someone?
Yeah, we don't have to find the full 105, but I mean, you know, we just, it's nice to get that down. If we can get it all down, that would.
Pardon? Hold it out over there, so.
So planning and zoning, I think I made just an adjustment. It was a weird number of hours, I just put 65. That's its current rate times $100, so that's.
Just leaving it as it is?
Well, it's $100 less.
Okay.
Based on this analysis. No change to, I just consolidated the planning board and the zoning board advertising. I don't know why they would be separate, so they're just consolidated, so no change though. All right.
And it was based on the increased, the real rates that Foster's charges, or whatever paper charges, the paper record, wasn't it? We upped it the year before, right? Or last year, rather, to recognize the real charges. The real rate chart. That's fine. I just want to make sure we didn't.
It's covered by revenue.
For sure.
So let, well, let's.
At one time, we had a very small number because
it
was a lot cheaper to advertise, but it's a lot more expensive now.
So of the 1050, we've spent this. All right, here's the two lines that we've consolidated.
Yeah.
Here's the current expense, so that's about half.
It will go up in the, not next part of December probably. We will go closer to the, because we have the blue one. It's finally gonna. It's coming for a consult, but it's actually gonna do his real. So there may be additional costs there. So anyways.
So, question is, are we good with this? Whatever it is, with this amount.
Yeah.
Okay. So government buildings. And this has been built with the 2% ATB in general. There was an increase in supplies based on expenditures this year. Water was really only this. There was some testing that really comes out of town hall maintenance.
Yeah. So back to supplies just for a moment. We've talked about procurement several times over the years. Are we, this is what we're talking about, this is like cleaning supplies?
Any supply that, you know, extension cords, whatever it might be, town hall, this for, not the police, but.
Right. And Richard manages that for us, right?
Yes, Richard Caroline.
Is he doing that for the transfer station?
No, he's doing it for the highway too.
And for highway, okay. I wonder if we can consolidate lines, but I mean, if it makes sense that they're, long as it's being managed by one person, I guess it's fine, but is it easier to keep separate for you, or for the county purposes, is it easier to keep them separated?
What's the other one that you want?
Because Richard manages procurement for supplies, for transfer, anything to highway, and he does town hall, does it make sense to have them all under one line, or does it make sense to keep them separate?
Well, it depends on whether you're talking about paper supplies, or whether you're talking about nuts, bolts, mixer supplies.
The highway is just doing the highway rather than doing the...
Yeah, so...
So, that's my next question, we haven't gotten there yet, but is that, it's not separated out, supplies is just generic, I don't remember.
Yeah, it's just generic.
Yeah, under highway?
Yeah.
Versus like maintenance of vehicle supplies, it's not broken out, right, it's all, okay, right, nevermind, I'll just scrap that.
Yeah, I mean, I, you know, unless there's some, I mean, I hear what you're saying, but,
No, it's...
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Sorry, I don't wanna slow us down.
So the, there could be some changes to this, I know Dennis at the last budget committee meeting was talking about salaries and having increased wages, but...
For water?
Yeah, rates, water and sewer, but as far as I know, they're still that.
Yeah.
Town hall maintenance, no change, highway shed, no change.
Town hall meeting, shouldn't that be better now that we've fixed the eight shed?
It's an isolation of the door, so...
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean, so we have a more efficient board.
I would probably think it's marginal, and, it's really more a function of how cold it is, I think, and or hot in the summer. But, do they come out of the same thing? No, one's electricity, but then one, just how cold it is. Probably has more of an impact than anything that we've done. Because we didn't do anything dramatic, as far as I know. I think it's more...
We don't have, we didn't replace the, it's just a component, right?
So, yes. That may not have any relationship to efficiency, I don't think. Highway shed's the same. Transfer station, we upped it because there are now two compactor sheds that need to be heated. Well, not at the same time, but nonetheless, you know, we should probably have a year's worth to kind of see how things shake out. Fire station, I'm sure this is up because of what quarter three looked like. Electricity in town hall, the same. Electricity in the highway is down, I think, probably because of how quarter three looked like. Transfer station is up. There's a new compactor. You know, we only run one at a time, so maybe there's minimal impact. I don't know, but it's a small increase. Electricity at the fire station is a small decrease, I think probably because of usage as of quarter three. Repairs and maintenance at town hall, I've got it at 10. We're thinking of painting and repairing the portico, doing mold remediation, which we do every year, and we have various service contracts that come out of here. Repairs and maintenance for the town shed, this went up 500. Jody, do you want to say what George is thinking of here?
Oh, yeah. The office that has the mold at the bottom, we can just cut off the bottom that has the moisture problem and just repanel it. It's not... Right. Yeah. No. So just like when you get water...
Is it drywall?
No. It's wood. One room, the bathroom is drywall, the office is wood. But he wants to put stairs in, and because you have the office and the bathroom, and then this all open space, and what they were thinking of putting up right now, the only way to get up there is a ladder, which isn't safe.
Right.
So to just put in some stairs that they can do themselves, and then finish off that flooring, so they have storage for up there.
So I know where the signs are now?
Way up high?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And an exhaust fan.
Oh, yes. I know. Sorry.
Repairs for the fire station. Chief Rutherford's, you know, told us that he has asked for the same amount.
Yep.
Repairs for the transfer station. George must have said we could reduce this.
Yeah, we just fixed everything, so, and we have a service contract with Atlantic to do our maintenance on our compactors and our baler. So.
Hydroplant license fee is pretty steady. The water district hydrants is steady unless they have a rate increase. This will get bigger once Chinburg comes online. Because there's some hydrants there. And this is, we'll have hydrant rental in Dover and Summersworth. And this is municipal taxes in Berwick and South Berwick. Cemetery, this is $1,000 increase to cover the laptop and software that they are looking for. Property liability, there was a small increase. Regional associations, there was a small increase. This is, these are next year's rates. We know that you get them both in for municipal association and SRPC. Okay, so here's, all right, you ready to kind of tackle things? So let me tell you what I did. I've got three levels of salaries. The chief, full-time salaries, and part-time salaries. Plus the incidentals, like overtime, board witnesses and stuff. Mm-hmm. So here's the chief's salary.
Yep.
I've taken all of the part-times, all of the full-time folks and put them here.
Mm-hmm.
And I would like to take the merit increase and put it here and just note it on the side. This is, you know, and it's a three, that it's, these are their full-time salaries this year, plus there's a 3% on that that will be handed out by the police as merit.
Mm-hmm.
So.
I'm torn on that.
Torn on what piece?
I know that you want to do it for privacy issues, but they're a town employee.
We'll have a list of the salaries. The people, names, salaries. It gets so confusing, you know, to try to think about this as a person, and now one of these is a sergeant, and this and that. So we'll have a printout. Name, rank, you know, whatever position, name, position, hourly rate, total compensation.
And it'll be in the town report.
Yep.
Okay.
So for budgetary and accounting purposes, it simplifies things tremendously. And
yep.
This is the boards that's talking about this, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So as long as it's information that's readily accessible to any resident that wants it.
Yeah, because like Boston
okay
puts like all of
Dover. Right?
Yeah,
the entire.
Absolutely. It's
like
public information.
The janitor.
Absolutely. What I would like to do is not have it be a budget issue. I mean, have it complicate the budget.
How did it complicate the budget?
Because this, which of these is down the sergeant's line? You have to, when the payroll comes in, you have to figure out which line to put the accounting to, rather than, all right, this payroll, these are the police full-time salaries. Boom.
But she has to anyway, because she has to put in the time for.
That's the timesheet part. That's not the after the payroll run from paychecks.
And they don't link.
And they what?
And they don't like.
Nope.
I hate things that don't.
Okay, so. You know, this is a board, really, Nancy, I hate to say this. This is a board workshop. I would prefer not to have any comments from anybody, if that's okay. Thank you.
So if it's just really for an accounting purpose, and information is not readily available, fine to simplify. That's fine right now.
Okay.
As long as folks understand that it's, the information is still available and we're not trying to hide who gets paid what, it is just for an accounting for to simplify whatever system we need to really find.
Mm-hmm. And take a look at other municipal budgets.
There's just one line.
Yep. All right. So overtime, this is what I think the chief is recommending, and this is just a note that, you know, it's hard. There are various ways that people either, their salaries either covered by New Hampshire retirement system or not, and depending on when they got hired, if they were full-time, and blah, blah, blah.
Right.
So that's just a note so that it helps with the calculation. Contracted services. I asked Chief Ducharme, he was thinking of reducing this to 60. I actually thought I had. I'd like to reduce this to 60 only because we have, he wanted to check back in, but because it has an exaggerated impact on the revenue side, I'd like to get this down to where he, his last known comment.
Okay.
So I'm going to do this like this. We can always change it.
Go back, yeah, 32 and 4. Go lower 32.
Maybe I change it here. Just a little bit. So if it is 60, it's not double, this would be, that is the issue. So let's change this to 90, which has an impact all over. It just says we are waiting to hear from him. So, that's what I mean. It's really difficult. We don't have all the data at this stage of the game. So, down here. I think everything else is the same. These are all just related to
uniforms.
What do you, this is how he gave it to us. This is his budget.
Yes. But remember the dry cleaning issue last year?
Wow.
So our officers are still going home, and with the drugs that they have to deal with, they're bringing their uniforms home, and I don't like that. So professionally cleaned is how they have to be serviced. They can't go through the UniFirst or whoever we use. So, but we're not using all of our UniFirst services. So,
well, what do you suggest? Because this is the budget that Chief Ducharme gave us.
Yes.
So, would you like to chat with him about that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can we put a pinhole in that?
Yeah, I'm gonna.
That's not gonna work.
No, I'm gonna highlight it.
I did.
Thank you.
We can put it in there.
Because I didn't know they only have 3 uniforms each, so they're not even getting a full week's worth of uniforms.
All right, so
you know, when we talked about it last year, was it, I guess?
Like, even if they're washing their own, they're still
Bob was saying
anything.
That, like, the state police get a stipend, I think he said, for dry cleaning services.
So they take care of it themselves, or they get a stipend?
But they have to, yeah, they have to take care of themselves, which doesn't really solve the issue that Jody's talking about of, you know, chemicals that may or may not get on their uniform.
Yeah, no, it's a good point. But, again, this is, you know, so chat with them and see how he wants to manage that. So this is the again the budget that Chief Rutherford presented to us. Although during the discussion he said, well, you know, it should be more. But this is so this is more than 2% too, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. So.
And that brings them to.
It's still minimum.
725, is that still?
It's still roughly minimum.
It's a match for a wheelhouse there. Right?
So yeah, adding $1,420 is not going to.
It doesn't get them fall, right?
Doesn't change.
That's what we want. Yeah, I don't.
So.
I'll stick with his recommendation for the moment.
For the moment, I've got this note. He wanted to add 500 to training. And that's
right?
The only other change. I mean, the payroll taxes change when this changes.
Right.
So.
You
good?
Yep.
It's for now.
All right, so the building inspector, this is an increase of 1 hour per week. So it's 4,100 in all. If we did 6 hours per week, which he, was his first recommendation, it would cost us 25,000 pretty much. So, you know, he'll come to us if he needs something prioritized that causes him to put in regularly more than 5 hours a week.
He's also the...
Health inspector.
No, is he getting that stipend too, or is it coming out of this budget inspector line?
Yeah, no,
it's
I did,
only like
I did 500, yeah, I did zero that out, so in some, okay. So yes, it's helping to source this.
Okay.
Right? You don't see it that way, but yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you want to put like a slash building inspector slash, or do you want to keep it separate because we still need a health inspector?
Yeah.
Well, he, what do you mean? He is our health inspector.
But
I think you should keep a line.
A line.
So health inspector, keep
oh,
a
yes,
so
we do have that line. It doesn't have anything in it right now.
Right.
Yeah, well, whatever. We can check when we're down there.
Because we're going to need to find.
You can't find, you can't lose sight of the fact that
correct.
We need one.
Correct.
So it ever comes to pass that Tom doesn't want to do that anymore.
Or we find someone who does want to do it and is willing to do it for $500 a year versus.
$80
Right, exactly.
Most of this is coming from the building.
No, I get that.
Yeah.
I get that.
Okay, so this is...
I'm so don't worry about it. No one beating down the door saying they want to be the health inspector. So.
No one's beating down the door for any
right,
job.
Right, right.
Okay, so this, let's kind of look at this. So here's the road agent salary.
Yeah.
There will be no increase, but there's no...
There has been, as far as this new position.
He is not having any position has been increased.
Right.
So, full-time staff. We had no other full-time staff, so this is all new.
Yep.
Right? And it is based on an hourly rate of this.
Okay.
But when we advertised it, we gave it a little range, 16, right?
15 to 17, I
okay,
think.
Okay, so I put this at the top of the range.
Yeah.
I stuck in 125 hours of overtime.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that's sufficient.
Mm-hmm.
Is that based on your ideas around climate, probably?
Yeah, that would, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So keep it straight in my head.
Yeah,
no,
I
don't
no, know. If it says
yeah.
2K, it's not 2, it's a number of hours.
Gotcha.
It's, payroll taxes, the Medicare part of payroll taxes that are in its system, health insurance.
That's a family plan?
Yep.
Okay.
What, rounded, life and disability.
Yep.
Now, I don't know if we're going to have any part-time labor savings, and it doesn't have to be here anyway. So, in total, when we talk to people, it's an additional $64,000.
Yep.
$64,000. So, but the salary piece is this.
Correct.
All right? So here's the part that I'm wondering if we can, if you can sit down with George or if there's any way to reduce this. It is so we've got part-time labor.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be the sort of Wayne Mike.
Yep.
So I've done $14 an hour for 20 hours a week.
Okay.
And we may need that. I don't know the answer to that.
Okay.
And then I've got an additional $20 an hour for snow plowing, and I must have done 500 hours.
Okay.
Now, this is for hourly people. This is not for George and not for the new person.
Okay.
So, do we have to budget 500? I don't know. This is how much we've used. We used 509 hours of seasonal folks in 2014-15.
Yeah.
326 in 15-16, 700 last year.
Yeah.
And we have one of those three part-timers this year.
Right, but we may want others to help spell.
Right.
I don't know that.
Right.
Right, so that, but, because we've talked about how we need to be safe with the deploying the people we had, you, and I don't, can't have them out there for 30 hours straight.
So for part-time labor?
So, but let's go back to the tab.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where this figure comes from. And it's a question. I don't know that it has a happy answer, but can it be reduced? It's already been, it is slightly reduced from the combined last year of for those two categories are. So this gets our part-time staff in one line.
Yeah, I think I'll be able to reduce it.
Okay.
Because that, you're putting part-time staff with winter staff.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, you can reduce it.
So you can think about that. Think about what.
I thought I did, but I no longer have any paperwork. So
okay.
It was stolen from me on budget night.
Okay.
I took it home.
So.
I know.
The payroll taxes, they've actually gone down because more is being covered by retirement system.
Yeah.
That's the only reason that you're seeing that.
Okay.
Do you have a question, Mike?
I don't know, just thinking more about the part-time staff, so.
I would bring it down to 20.
At least from the, can you go back to the.
The detail?
The detail.
Yes, of course.
So, the actual part-time labor line, that one there.
Yeah, that's the question. Do we need, so we've got,
we
have two full-time
people.
People.
I don't think you would need them.
So yeah, so you're going to use a part-timer, if we had a third part-timer during the week, if Mike Spinney comes in as he does now, and then your flagger or whatever. And then I also found out, I did some research, in the summertime we can hire a 16, 17-year-old to do all the weed whacking and all the easy stuff while our full-timers are doing, I don't want to say more important stuff.
Sure.
More licensed stuff.
Yeah.
So we can do a cost savings there when we only hire a seasonal summertime kid help that wants to get their foot in the door in this direction.
So how if we don't, so I think what you're saying is that we don't need somebody 20 hours per week, a third person 20 hours per week, 52 weeks a year.
Correct.
So how should we think that through then? Do you want to think about it a little bit?
Yeah, the third person is going to be helping on like some culvert work, not
very
dramatic stuff like, but the ditch work.
If it's completely seasonal, this is like 20 hours every week, 52 weeks, $14 an hour.
Reduce it to 15 hours a week.
That's not a reduction. Oh, I'm sorry, it is. I'm sorry. I was looking at the hourly rate.
Because I can't guarantee like how many weeks right now.
Right.
But I can go back and talk to George about it and say, like, so instead of 20 hours per week, you got 15 hours a week. And in the summer months, it may be 30. And in the winter months, it may be less. Does that make sense?
Definitely.
Okay.
Right, so we're just looking for some average that
right.
that makes sense.
Okay.
All right, so now we still have 500 snowplow hours.
Mm-hmm.
So you can think about that if you want to. And
we're good. Depending on the winter, we are expecting a bad winter. We were overplowing last year, so 700 hours was a lot. Our roads were great because we oversalted and overworked our guys. That's why they all left, to be honest with you. They all said we should have gone home and rested, and we didn't. So, So even with, this year was the year we had like all those blizzards right in a row, right? Was that this year?
No, we had a lot of
ice.
George has already said that he would like to implement the practices that they use over in either Berwick or South Berwick, whatever department he came from. So it'll be interesting to see how that works.
Well, he's also going to the Green Pro Snow.
Right. No, yeah, so
Green
I think
Snow,
all these things are
yeah.
may have an impact, a positive impact from a budgetary standpoint. So.
Let's leave it at 5 for now.
We'll see how it goes, right, yeah.
Right. So, let's go back. So we reduce this, and the payroll taxes get reduced accordingly, so that's... Do you want me to leave this message? Let me just say snow plow, or do you want to...
I make a note about this in the winter, if the snow plow help, maybe just a note so we don't lose sight, but... I mean, I would keep the how can we reduce this, but I can just put in winter help, maybe, or something like that.
All right, so let me just say, so what we did was we reviewed labor, reduce non-plow. Can we review snow plow hours? You know, it doesn't stop us from trying to get a pool, right?
Right.
So it just, we still would love a pool, and so we're not, we only have three trucks, so we're never gonna be paying for more than three trucks. It just, who's staffing those three trucks?
But we don't wanna burn people out.
Exactly.
Pool would be very important, I would think.
Yeah. Okay, so there's that. Health and life, we've brought upstairs. Safety shoes, I think George has reviewed all of these.
Yep, we went over, these are the numbers we plugged in with you the other day, right?
Yep, so okay. Safety equipment up, bed of health, you know, doubled. We've got two people now. This is, cell phone is essentially the same. So equipment, so we've been, this is an increase in that equipment line. It's pretty significant. This is a revised figure here. So we need to look at last, what we started out with last year. So this $6,000 increase
okay.
is going to a $1,400 trailer. He talked to us about that. I'm not saying we're accepting all of this. I'm just saying what the makeup of this is.
And he meant to talk to you guys about this one.
$1,400. Oh, were you not here when he came to?
That's
oh,
fine.
Okay.
No, I'm just.
So he talked about a $1,400 trailer.
So, do you want me to explain it?
Yeah.
The trailer makes sense. It looked like a lawnmower.
That's exactly what it was. We've been using that giant trailer to move the little tiny lawnmower. So, just a little tiny little thing
yeah.
will save on gas and tires and everything else.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And then the joint loss, they need an explosion proof flammable cabinet. Which meets those safety standards. And then the thing that they have is Mike's Minis, and it's being taken out of there. So they have no place for their lunches and stuff like that.
Okay.
So
that's pretty cheap.
And then just other things. They have less equipment or less supplies in their shed.
They want just like a small, like a dorm room type refrigerator?
Probably the
taller one.
At least
one,
the little
fine.
Taller one,
yeah.
But that's like $200 at the most.
Yeah.
So, but they have,
and this is now,
$1,400. Oh, it is $1,400, okay, and the explosion.
I don't know.
The explosion
yeah.
and cabinet
really
can be.
I would say that, you know, I would appreciate George looking at this line and seeing if we can at all reduce it. It is true that all the snow plow, repairs to the snow plow and blades and whatnot should be coming out of this line, but
where are
still, that, well, I think it's been mixed. So this reflects.
Well, have they been actually built to that line? So that's why we're building it up?
They've
or
been mixed all season.
They've been built, they were,
supplies.
I found them in the vehicle line.
Vehicle line.
I don't think they belong there.
Sure.
The vehicle line should tell us what
physically
is.
Physically the vehicle.
The vehicle,
not
all of this associated equipment.
Gotcha.
So, which, that should come out of the equipment line. So this line probably would have needed an increase anyway to bump up, to incorporate as we straighten out what gets
okay.
counted
so the,
for.
I'm just trying to keep it straight in my mind. So it's a $4,000, $3,200 increase.
$6,000.
Oh, it's four.
Yeah,
I was like $6,800.
Yeah, this, yeah, don't.
So a $6,000 increase. Obviously, it's not a $1,400 trail and explosive
cost
several thousand dollars. So that's, I guess.
I would like to look at this.
Well, it really makes a lot more sense if that's where the actual plow equipment, blades and things like that are coming out of there. Now it makes sense.
Yes, but if we did some major maintenance to all of these things this year, you know, this is a high bump. It's just a high bump. So if there's any way to, you know, this is maybe
the,
an opportunity.
The plow gear is going to be every year. It's an every year maintenance issue. It's not.
There
sometimes
may
it
be some.
A couple of times a season, depending on.
It depends that there were a lot
giant boulders that to the rope.
Yeah. So anyway, that's an opportunity. Uniforms, supplies has been upped up by 2,000. Vehicle repair and maintenance is up by 6,000. So these are difficult things to try to. Justify.
Well, the GMC is on, pretty much on its last leg. Dover said that, you know, it's supposed to be replaced in 2020, and he said sooner rather than later. And it's being, it's still not back. So, and then the intern, because it was, it's doing more work than it was designed to do.
Yeah.
So, it's going to have maintenance issues this year. That's why it blows so many hoses, and that's why it blows so many gaskets. And so,
yeah,
but are those expensive? Because this is what will come out. Sonny
yes.
will know exactly how much these things cost and say, well, yeah, but that's not
right.
as much as I
But some of those, but replacing some of these hoses and some of these things, we're now going to be able to do in-house because of the supplies and the equipment that we buy for them to be able to do them in-house.
Well, then does that
right.
argue that we should reduce this from the 15,000 that we're suggesting?
You still have that crappy backhoe.
Exactly.
It still
well,
doesn't have heat
that.
And electricity. I mean, heat and...
The transmission goes
constantly. Yeah. So if
Sonny
can take a look at that backhoe and fix it...
Amen. I'll do it. Ask me if he'll come over and take, if he has experience with it, take a look
yeah.
at it. I mean, I think that's...
All right. This is
well, because look, I mean, we have, and I don't say this disparagingly. I mean, he's a naysayer a lot of times because he's knowledgeable in these things, whereas we may not be. You know, I mean, I'm not a mechanic, so yeah, I would like him to go over and take a look at it.
I'm fine with that.
Yeah.
I mean, if George is comfortable, George can just ask him. So, but I'm merely pointing out that last year we had 13,000 in as a combination of equipment and vehicle repairs and maintenance. And we've just exploded that to 15
I think George is right.
to 25.
Just based on the backhoe. I don't know how you would change it, but I would move it down. This does not give me great joy to increase these lines, but...
So doing...
I mean, we don't know.
13 to...
Here, you know what? I'm going to...
13
this is a bad... Let me do this. Should be closer together.
Okay. Yeah, same together.
Yeah. It's 12,000. It's probably 12,000 dollars. All right. You can ponder that.
Let's talk to George about this a little more, and I think it would be a good idea to bring in people like Sonny, and I wonder if there's anyone else who does automotive repair, on heavy machinery, that in town might be able to give us their opinion.
The guy that works with Sonny over at
C&J,
Joe something.
Or at the very least, at least just Sonny, see if he doesn't mind. And maybe it's just during the day he comes and chats with one of us and we talk about whatever it's most convenient for him. But before a meeting, we have another budget workshop. We ask him to come in and see if he thinks that's reasonable after looking at the equipment.
So who's going to organize that?
Okay, I don't mind calling if you want to call him.
Yeah, I don't have.
But we shouldn't just do this without George. I mean, this is
right.
Well,
I'll talk to George first.
Yeah. He probably knows something. He seems to know everybody.
Okay, so that's a big increase.
Sure,
I'll just point that out.
It is.
Vehicle fuel.
But here's the deal, though, and I don't start preaching the choir, but this equipment is very expensive, right? To begin with. If you don't maintain it properly, it becomes more expensive, right? So you want to, it's a lot cheaper to repair things than to buy a whole new truck, if possible, so. And, but, you know, the GMC, when we buy equipment, and we truly do beat the hell out of it, not in a bad way, but when we plow roads, it's, I don't do this for a living, but I've gone out a few times with the crew, and it takes a toll just on your body being in that truck, being bounced around, and it's, you know, imagine what it does to the actual truck. It's just...
Well, that, you know, that's wonderful anecdotal narrative. But, you know, if we're going to make arguments,
I think the people that would make that argument understand that because they have been involved. Some of the folks that would make that argument, that would be naysayers, have been involved with that and understand that. So
I would still argue that we don't have the data that I would like to have in order to review all of this.
Okay.
I mean, I would like to see how much we've been spending on repairs for each of these individuals across the years since we've had them individually. So, you know, we don't keep things at that level. It's difficult for us to invest resources in order to build that. But that's what I would like. And that helps you justify, you know, things like this. If we had seen that the GMC is going like this, that, you know, but...
Well, I'm trying to think of what year it is. It's on the CIP. I don't remember what year it is.
2020 is for the GMC.
But it's when they want to replace, but what year was it purchased, or what manufacturer year was it? Oh.
12 years ago or so.
And it was undersized or under whatever. Under
right, at the time. So, I mean, if it's a 12-year-old truck that we've been using as a lot of truck, then
right,
not
we've
meant
been using
for that.
It as a commercial truck with the ability to drive it without a CDL.
Right.
Well, it doesn't have the air brakes, and we put extra weight in it.
I agree. I did not know this. I have learned this over the past year.
Yeah.
Well, none of us were here when it was purchased. I'm not trying to look back at blame. I'm just saying, but so we can't.
But that is a fact.
We can't solve that because we weren't here.
Right.
When
that
it
is
happened,
a fact
so.
Associated with that GMC.
Right.
We didn't buy it as a snowplow truck. We bought it so that, you know, the road agent at the time, who didn't have a CDL, was allowed to drive it.
Right.
And so it's under, it's not sized or not outfitted appropriately for the amount of equipment and the use that it gets. So that part, you know, that narrative, I can say, it's just whether that all justifies this kind of an increase. And that's my only point.
Okay.
Yeah. Vehicle fuel is up 500. Whether that's okay, I don't particularly have a problem. I might have kept it the same, but I don't have a problem. I don't know why Jeff increased it to 9. I'm not sure we're going to need that, but whatever.
Vehicle prices have gone up. I mean, and now we're going to go up a little more in the wintertime. Because the price always goes up in the wintertime, right? Because the mix changes. And we'll go back down, and then we'll go back up depending on the season. So that one, I don't see that much of a.
Well, it's not that much. It's not, you know, it's not the. So, you know, so had Jeff not, and this is Jeff, during the course of this year, asked it to be bumped to 9,000. If it had not been bumped to 9,000, we'd probably, at the end of quarter three, had spent about 75%, which includes the heavy use winter months as well as the lesser use.
This would be right in line for the third quarter.
So that's why I think the 8,500 would have been fine, but it's not that much money. So
what are you recommending?
I don't know that I don't. I'm not. Let's see. If I don't think anybody else did their increase in fuel.
I'm kind of
backing
that because they're going to be doing less miles.
The police did not go up on their vehicle fuel.
What was happening is that they were plowing more often than they needed to. That's why.
Oh, I see what you're saying. I get you. I'm with
you.
So vehicle, so neither the police nor the fire went up on their allotment of vehicle fuel. Just a point of information. So the question is going to be, well, why? It's my question, and I would say it would be somebody's question. Why is there?
Okay,
let's
make it 85.
85. All right, signs. We know that we are making an all-out effort to at least upgrade stop signs. So this includes
every year.
$2,000 plus another $1,500 for general purpose sign replacement.
Mikey might not have been here, but we buy in bulk from another company. They're $65, $69 each instead of $85 each if we buy in bulk.
He was coming to, well, it doesn't mean the barricade, it's convenient, I guess.
He had another mail.
There's some place in
Nebraska,
Tennessee.
That
was significantly cheaper.
Kentucky.
Why we weren't here before, whatever it was, somewhere else.
Right. And if we buy in bulk, and they wouldn't order us, like we needed the two, they said they only have one in stock. If you don't order more, you can't buy them right now. I don't know why.
I remember that conversation. But
right.
So, part of the. So, our stop signs and other associated street signs are not compliant. We get that. But there was also an issue with our street signs, too, right? Like the names of the sign of the street.
Yes.
Wasn't there an issue there that we were supposed to be.
Well, all of the signs have to have the same standard of whatever reflective ability.
We haven't. Now, for several years, we robbed that line to pay for other things that were more pressing, you know, and rightfully so. But have we made any? Was there any progress made in the last?
Because
we didn't do that. We didn't rate it this year, and we didn't rate it last year. Was there any progress made over the, you know, the warm months to buy anything before?
Well, let's look to see what the expenses are. I'm not sure if I can. I know the answer. Do you see
signs? Right there. Yeah, you're on.
So, yeah, no, we haven't spent. We've only spent this.
And those are for probably
the accidents. Can't change
what
happened in the past. We're just going to have to move forward.
Yeah.
So I would implore George, when it's warm out, I know he's got a lot of things to think about, but not to lose sight of replacing signs.
Oh, he has a whole list of things ready to go. Day one, he was like, have you sat down with him yet? Oh, you haven't even had a chance to meet him.
So, oh, well, let me go on.
No,
it's okay.
It bothers me when I budget money to have things done.
Well, I understand, but you know what? It's going to get
money
elsewhere in the
book,
you know.
It's been 4 years now. I've been hearing the same story for 4 years, so. Maybe just someone started.
Well, no, I think that there were some upgrades done. I think there were. I mean, I don't think that you would see that balance necessarily on the sign line for prior years. You'd have to look in your book, but, you know. Whatever money we were putting in was not a whole lot anyway, right? So, because it cost $2,000 just for 30,
just 26
or whatever stop signs.
Yeah.
All right, line striping is at 4. You know, it would be helpful, Jody, and I can find, I'm going to highlight this if you don't mind. I can find Jeff's sort of thumbnail for how much it cost you line striping. But it would be helpful to have a plan. You know, what are we going to line stripe? What are we going to line stripe? And is some of it, you know, with the equipment, you know, is it parking lots? And we can rent equipment. If we're doing any long lines, that particular line could increase because we're doing long line striping, which are roads.
We have no long line striping planned for this year.
Okay, that's helpful to know. So then we could probably reduce this.
Yeah.
Good thing.
And the town was just done. Do you want to redo the middle of town again? They're still bright, aren't they?
I only want to do what we need to do. But I don't know what that is.
We should go and look just to make sure there aren't certain. I don't know what our parking lot looks like out here. I didn't even know this, but
it needs to be paved before.
But I'm just going to say it needs to be repaved, so that's probably a moot point. But
I mean, we could go back and look at.
Ask George if there are places he thinks that need priorities that have to be done. But I think the village, for the most part, is fine. But
I'm going to send him a message now before I forget.
All right, so tree maintenance, we will have spent close to $5,000 this year. We have to reduce it, right? And so right now I have $5,000 for next year. I've reduced it arbitrarily. But I think George and Jody are good with that. Sand and gravel is increased. They're hoping to do more in-house shoulder work.
Here's about trees. We never took down. Jeff had a whole list of trees that they need to be done. Did that ever actually go down?
I think George is looking for a quote for $4,000.
For all those, the same amount of work?
No.
No, to do
to do what he can for $4,000. Because that's what's left in this year's budget.
So, okay.
What if we didn't do any of that tree work, and because you have that shortfall on the taxes?
Right, we did a PO for this, then we decided to hold it off because things were going crazy. And so then we looked at it again, and there's now $4,000, a little bit more. And so we amended the PO for, if you weren't here, that's, we amended it to $4,000. And with the instruction to George, do what you can.
Okay.
That's where it stands. So with that in mind, that some work will be done, $4,000, actually $5,000 in all, because there was one tree that taken care of with, because of the storm.
Right.
That we've got, you know, $5,000.
Right.
Yeah, and George says once they're on the ground, he can do it.
You're actually easier.
Sure.
James Lott.
Yeah, right.
Sand and gravel is up. They're planning on doing more in-house shoulder work. So, there you go. Street sweeping, this is what, you know, it's been sort of running about that.
Yeah.
Cold patch hot mix, we doubled that. Again, because we're planning on doing more in-house work.
Oh, I'm just like, I'm looking at one of them.
Yeah, she was covering the floor.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Salt, we've lowered because the price is lower, and hopefully, you know, we will have techniques that minimize or maximize, you know what I mean, that take the best advantage of the salt so we're not over-salting.
Right.
Now, roadside mowing, we didn't do it this year because we wanted to, we were going to, this was the quote, which is more than what we had budgeted for, but that person's equipment died.
Yeah.
The person who would do it for this, his equipment died, it was enough
or
dead.
Or he's not doing anything anymore.
Yeah, because he couldn't manage his equipment failures. This was the new one, his equipment died, and so the current plan is to buy a roadside mowing attachment else, put $4,500 back in the slot.
And how much would you assume that the attachment will cost?
$25 is what's in the CIP that I will show you in a minute.
Oh, okay. Not going to be a surprise when I go to the meeting next Thursday.
There may be a few surprises, but we'll go over them today.
Oh,
and I'll reprint the CIP for you.
Oh, thank you. Appreciate
but
that.
I can't, you know, I would have had stuff be, you know, really, I've been doing this right up until.
No, I really appreciate it. But, okay, so, and we.
And I don't know, George was still.
We feel confident that the machinery that we have now, we get an attachment that will go on it.
No, we don't. George was still exploring that, so I know I can't answer
okay.
that. Do you know?
I'm not going to stick it on the side of the backhoe then if it doesn't work.
No, we're going to stick it on the Bobcat.
Does he know if it fits?
So you can, we're still looking into it. But
okay.
This is kind of what it would look like.
Is it, and it's heavy duty enough to.
That's what you can put on the Bobcat. Problem is, if you see the Bobcat, you have tires that has tracks. The tracks work better when you're doing roadside mowing.
Yep.
So that's where his theory was.
Do you know why? I mean, why do they work better? What is it?
The tire, because if you're in mud, the traction of a track gets you out. That's why excavators and all those big equipment have tracks and not tires.
But it's on the side of the road, so what is it?
But
because it's in the ditch,
you can
it's
go
in
and
the
go
ditches.
To the side, yeah.
Right.
Because you don't just do just the ditch line, you go up a little bit, like
yeah.
on the side of the hills
yeah.
and things.
Yeah. So, and then some of your other attachments, this is one that's the $25,000 version. So,
again, it's on a track.
Right.
But it's also at the front, so it's kind of.
So,
I like the idea of having it because you just go up and so it has tracks, you can manage to go on the side.
Yeah. And then you're thinking of something like this.
On the side of a truck.
Yeah,
something
it would
like
have to be.
550 or something.
Right. So.
It's such a damn what's this.
So anyway, there's a note here, and that's why it's yellow, because You know, and this is yellow only because if we have some idea.
Yeah, and he's got, George has taken that course right on.
November, at the end of November, we couldn't get him into the early November, it was full, so we're hoping that the snows aren't there.
You know, this street salt has never really sat well with me. It just sort of went along.
Who has a post on bigs?
Yeah.
But it's what the state recommends. From a stormwater point of view, stormwater people don't like dirt. Don't like silt because it adds silt to the rivers and impaired waterways.
I like the sand on little hills, they have more traction.
I do too, as a user.
Right, that's what I mean.
Yes, so. As a walker. You know, put sand on the sidewalks. Don't put salt.
Salt,
because I want the traction of the sand. I feel comfortable when I see sand.
Yeah,
So it's the same. It's the same principle. So I get that. I can't resolve that sort of tension between.
Yeah, no. But George was mentioning something they do over at Kiffin Berwick, right?
Yes.
What they did there, and I don't remember, but what happened? Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah, that's right.
What's that? On a backhoe?
Yeah.
That's
on the skid steer.
Oh, that is on the skid. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's cute. Is that also 25 within the 25?
Let me check.
Yeah.
I had to.
Well, I was going to be more efficient than that, but the Bobcat works. And how long is the Bobcat? Has there been an effect about it?
That's on the CIP too.
So that's the this thing needs. You don't buy a roadside mowing attachment. We need to add for the
primary. Okay, all right.
Stormwater management. I want to review the detail behind this. Right now, this is kind of like a placeholder.
Okay.
But this is the year when we have to have some reporting.
Oh,
for the new permit.
Yeah.
And there is a possibility of collaboration is kind of cohering. It's getting, you know, a coherent mix. With the Stormwater Coalition.
Yeah.
George was with me at the last meeting. So this is a placeholder for things that we might yet need. Catch basin cleaning, no change, road surface. I would prefer to have, as you know,
everything,
all
right.
Road maintenance in this one line. It's a pain in the tush. So you can think about whether you object to that or you would, you know, because you've got. Because you're trying to think of the project, it's one, you know, it's kind of like one thing, road maintenance. And now you've got some money here, and you've got some money there. So you all can be thinking about that. So we've increased, just so that you know, we've increased the highway department overall budget, exclusive of salary, by $11,000. Exclusive of salary.
It'll pay for itself in 5 years. Until I retire the duty.
I'm still stuck on the brush hog. As it goes outside. Yeah. Alright.
$11,000, huh?
Yeah.
PSA.
So that, you know, we're going to have to figure this one out here. You were listening to me. We've increased the highway department budget by almost $11,000, exclusive of the salary increase. So you need to be, you know, so I didn't agree with your comment the other night, as you said, that we're saving money with this new person. I don't think we're saving money. They may be other good reasons to hire a full-time person. We're not.
But we are. We will. We will.
Years down the road.
But we're setting them up for it.
So we're also returning to a place where we should have been. We had been in the past. We should have been.
All of those narratives. I agree with all of those narratives. We need to be careful about that. This
there are
that there's an immediate savings because of this person.
We never did. We have equipment that was purchased so we could do things in house, and then never materialized. Right. So
now we've got that second
person
to help us, and we're increasing the budget by $11,000.
Right.
That's all I'm saying.
So if they do their own cutting and patching this year. They could do more cutting and patching. Remember last year they spent $15,000 to do like two spots. It was the bottom of my hill, and then there was a couple, and I forget the get weird. They hired crew to do it. And then we had the police flag it and the agent watch it. And
the police may still have to flag it.
Were there, I'm trying to think.
But what I mean is, before we had somebody standing there watching.
Are there any compression issues that we have to worry about? Like with a
compaction.
When they compact, even with it's just when we're cutting, there's still no issues there. We can still do it ourselves.
Yeah, we have compacting.
That will. All
right. Do. You do?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Street lighting. This doesn't account for some outstanding repair requests that we have, but we don't know when they're gonna honor them. So I'm just.
Oh, I know.
I'm just highlighting it.
Who changes the lights in Stockdale?
I think PSNH or Eversource, I believe we have a request in. Caroline has said we've got some outstanding repair requests with Eversource.
Okay.
I don't know, you should ask her, because I don't know where they are. I just know that there are outstanding repair requests that she thinks could cost us about $2,500. If we don't know when they're going to do it, we don't know. So the budget for the transfer station covers the 2% increase of the people we have now. I didn't know what to do about a Saturday help. We don't have anybody yet.
We are spending it.
Well, this is. So we still have. We're just about using it because we had 28,000, right?
Yeah.
So this is the 2% increase for our current people.
Right.
And the hours they work per week. Right. So we're pretty much at the 28,000.
So Russ is going to be more managing it, per se.
Yes.
So, and he actually recommended the increasing the other guys. He actually was like, you know, we should. So I didn't know if we could do more than that.
So if he's going to have more managerial responsibilities, does he get a higher rate of pay?
He was actually more concerned with the other guys.
He was admirable, but I mean, he can have more responsibility than him, right? So,
yes.
Does the 97 represent?
This is his hourly. This is what their hourly rate
there
should
there
be.
It is over there. Okay.
11.54 for Ross. 10.71 for Paul. And 10.92 for Armand. So, what are you wanting to do about this line? This line?
How bad would it be if you brought it up to 12, 11, and 11?
So he was looking to increase not their hours, their rate?
Yeah.
$648.
Okay.
You want to go with that?
I would recommend that. And then the part-time help, if we ever get it, they're just covering for one of them being out anyway.
So that represents the. So we wouldn't be giving them the 2% across the board on top of that?
No.
For that line, not for an individual. This, you know, we haven't increased this line for a number of years because it was like over budget. Remember somebody asked me, like, how come the transfer station attendants aren't getting the across the board? This is last year. I said, they are. The same budget will accommodate, they're getting the 2% across the board.
Right.
And so this.
Because we didn't have full complement.
I think.
We didn't have three in all year.
Maybe. I think that it was that line has had a little, you know, we've started to budget more precisely than was budgeted in the past, so I don't know how that came about, but we have not had to increase that overall line for a bit. We may even decreased it. All right, so no change to lines until we get to the phone, which is a decrease. This is what Caroline said, they're switching from, she's putting in a switch from Verizon or somebody to our First Light. So.
The uniform line, is it still, is that the bare minimum of the contract, $3,000?
No, it's a minimum of $50 a week, I think.
I don't know the details.
So.
I just want, not everyone is taking advantage of the full.
Right, that's correct. That's correct. So if you want to see.
Right, so.
Yeah.
Can we reduce the line if possible?
Yeah, you go to 20.
Let's look at quarter, well, let's look at quarter three. Let's see what we're doing here. This is sanitation. So we have grossly underused it. I don't know whether that's because we didn't have somebody there all year. We have to be careful, right?
We didn't start it till April.
Oh, okay. So this is 4 months
worth. Right, yeah, so.
So, but we're not using it all. Some use parts of it, some don't. They have, in the winter months, they're going to be using more of the warm onesies kind of thing. The highway department uses it, but it depends on your work. There is a minimum that we have to pay each week, and then we pay per piece if it goes above and beyond that amount.
So the 559, which is only 4 months worth of data.
Six.
Nine months of the year. Mm-hmm. That represents the highway uniforms and transfer station. So Jeff used to get the shirts and all that stuff. Right?
Yeah, he had 11.
Every day of the week stuff.
Yep.
So let's just assume George is going to do that too.
Yes, he is.
And then we'll have George's assistant.
Yep.
Right, that we will just assume we'll do that.
Right.
That's a new person that we didn't have.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And now a factor in that not all the guys at the transfer station want those services. Can we still reduce the line?
Yeah, we can.
We still can, right?
Yeah,
I think we can probably do 28. You can easily do 28.
Really? I was going to say, why can't we reduce it to 2? I mean,
let me check on, put another pin
on
that.
You said 50, yeah. You said 50.
I thought it was 50 a week. But let me double check that. It could be less. Let me check. Maybe I have it in my email.
Yeah, if you can kind of figure out based on current usage, you know, the new person, all of those things, that the details that you
you want to run over and get a bill?
No, maybe there's time. So if there's time afterwards, though, how does that sound? I don't want us to get.
Yeah.
So if it's $50 every week, 52 weeks out of the year, that's $2,600. Or your budget, $3,000, so it's not like we're...
Oh, I see. We just didn't use it. I guess I don't know why.
Right, so I would be saying, you know, no.
So let's leave it.
We don't have a full year, and we didn't have...
Yeah, but the seventh,
full
you know,
so.
A full year based on the current usage for those months. What did we use?
It was 559, right? That was it.
So that's 6 months. Maybe that's, I think I did that wrong. All right, so it would be this if we'd use it for the whole year at that rate.
Something's not adding up. I think Dre's right. Put a pen in it and we come back and get if we can.
Okay.
We can reduce it.
Okay, so I'll just leave it there. Lamprey Regional, this is up. Let me see if I've got some information there. So municipal solid waste. So here's how that line got calculated.
Right.
So it was $64 a ton in FY17.
Yeah.
$65 a ton in FY18 according to the contract.
Right.
So I'm budgeting 690 tons, which is a 5% increase in tonnage.
Okay.
Because we have new developments. You know, we have new housing,
those Chinburg houses are all being built.
So 5% increase in tonnage times the dollar increase in per ton, and that gives us this.
Okay.
This 6.8% increase.
That's just the tipping fees.
Just the tipping fees. And that's where we should get some savings, right? So, is there, Jody, are you wanting to think about this a little more?
Can you go back to your...
Yes, absolutely.
Sorry.
No, no. So, this is based on...
So we're gonna pay
$65 a ton. This 690 tons represents a 5% increase in tonnage. The what we budgeted on last year.
I think we're gonna be paying 56, because right now we're paying 65. I mean, 66. I know it goes up $1 a year for the first couple of years. And then it goes up to $1.50.
So we were wrong last year, it wasn't $64 a ton, it was $65 a ton?
We've been paying $65 a ton a year.
So now it's going up to, okay.
It's going up to 66.
Yeah. It goes up $1 a year, and then in like year 7, it goes up to $1.50 more.
Well, I'm not interested in getting this number to go up even more. So maybe a 2% increase rather than a 5% increase. I mean, I was just doing this, you know.
Well, think about how many houses it is, right? Let's just take Chinburg. There are 15 potential lots there, right? I believe in that subdivision. There's 13. I want to say 15. And there are, is it four or five houses? Five houses that are actually there right now. There are 10 more houses. Is that really going to increase your overall 5%?
Yeah, that's a good point. So
I mean,
what's a better, just, I don't want to spend a whole lot of time. 1%?
All right.
Throw 2, I guess.
2%? Okay. So I'm going to highlight this because I'm not going to do that right now.
Not,
so
I mean, that's not to say that.
Times.
Other houses can't be built during the year.
Right,
but
no,
even
no,
that,
but,
I mean, you
but
think
still,
about your overall
if you look
stock,
at the overall
yeah.
thing and how what percentage increase does the two houses represent,
yes.
or five houses.
Yeah, so if you send out three shipments of waste a month at 16 tons times 12 months is 576 tons of waste.
What did you just calculate this morning?
So I took our actual bills, and
yes.
we send out solid waste. They've been getting 14 to 16 in each barrel, and we shipped it out three times in a month, times 12 months was 576 tons.
Yeah, this is, I looked at an annual figure though, because if you've got three deliveries in a month, then maybe there's something weird about when the months split,
mm-hmm.
and some months may have had 1 month, or 2 months may have had five. Do you know what I mean? I mean, I did find this figure based on an annual from Caroline.
Yeah,
so
that includes demo.
So,
because the bill comes all in one.
I don't remember. I just remember.
Yeah.
So, are you saying that this is 690? We didn't do 690, and
we could have, but that includes demo too.
That we pay for differently?
No, unfortunately.
Well, okay.
Yeah.
So then we're okay.
Yeah, I was just doing
all
right.
All
right. Waste.
Okay,
so
I should put municipal solid waste slash demo, maybe, right?
Yeah.
Now the hauling.
Mm-hmm.
So in FY17 it was $228 per haul,
mm-hmm.
and we budgeted for 75 hauls. So now I budgeted for 55 hauls, and the truck hauling is not getting sent, and I use $240 a haul.
Did you say that meeting?
Their meeting is soon, yeah.
So that's where this.
So we're paying, right now we're paying $5.75 a mile. And that's where the limited hauls is gonna save us money.
Right, so we've used this based on the current, you know, what it costs us to do a haul.
Mm-hmm.
So it's $228 right now with fuel prices right this very minute, and the number of miles that they charge us,
mm-hmm.
or whatever it is. We don't charge fuel, they just charge us per mile.
Right.
So this is what it is for the round trip, however they calculate it. It's
yep.
$228 per haul, and we budgeted 75 hauls. So now we're budgeting 55 hauls, but I don't know what the, we can't calculate that, so I just used a 5% increase of $240, and that's where I got this $13,200.
Okay.
So as soon as we get
and
some.
When was it last year?
17.6, so there's a $4,500 decrease.
Good.
Now, could this be more if the you know, depending on what happens? I don't know, but that's how it's currently based. And if your data, let's go back to this for a minute. If your data supports fewer than 55 hauls a year, then we can change that number. You know, it's still kind of early,
mm-hmm.
right?
I
so
know,
it's hard. Yeah, it's hard to do that. But that's what it's currently based on. This is Pinard, not Pinard, Shipyard.
Yep.
So, you know, we just haven't been, he hasn't increased his prices. So, you know, based on George, based on Jody, we're recommending $5,000. This is to cover the maintenance contracts that we now have on a little bit more equipment on two compactors. So that's that
and
increase. And yes, what I keep forgetting about, a cardboard baler.
Yes.
Cardboard baler.
No,
I can't. No, no,
that's what you're, is that what you were thinking, right?
Yeah, I think, well, we don't have, what do you mean? We don't have a baler anymore. Why do we have a service contract with a baler? Cardboard. Oh, yeah, I see that machine. I can see it now. It's right in the corner.
Yeah.
Disposal of metal and tires, $3,800. We get some revenue on the other side.
Yeah.
Revenue on the other side of this. This is a fixed cost for the Lamprey Waste Co-op. Brush chipping. We'll see if George, if he, I don't know that he's, we've got this review because maybe he wanted to see what it was going to cost him to go out and look for, get this year's. I don't remember why we have review here, but it's there. Maybe we just get rid of it.
What do we do?
Yeah, I don't know. He was gonna, he felt that he could do, he was gonna do $3,500 worth of brush chipping this year.
He felt like he was?
Yes. So, because
okay.
he needs to get that pile down. He doesn't
right.
know if he can do it all, so.
Right.
So I guess we should keep it, we'll keep it, and we'll see if we have to make any changes. No change to FEMA emergency management, thanks per Ducharme.
Okay.
Here's the help. There's no change to the ambulance service.
Mm-hmm.
This is, I can put a buck. I mean, the line is still there, but
yeah,
it means something different. We can put the buck. Animal control officer, these are the changes that Chief Ducharme recommended. That's that. General assistance, I just copied last year's figures. Now,
how are we
doing?
Yeah, in quarter three.
Let's bring it up.
I know we're always leery of making changes, but.
Well, it's a little bit like special ed.
I know, but if we look at several years worth of.
We've reduced
info,
it.
Is
yeah.
There, is there room again to.
Yes, I think so.
Where we could comfortably make. I mean, I get that you never know what a given year is going to bring.
No, and the winter months are more problematic
sure.
because of heating
sure.
than the summer months. So if you think that maybe we would double this in the remaining months, that's like, it still
it
gives
is.
Us,
still.
You know, I would say we could easily reduce it, comfortably reduce it to 20.
I hate to raise and appropriate money
mm-hmm.
just because. I mean,
mm-hmm.
you know, I don't think any of us want to do that. So
right.
If we have data that shows we haven't
yeah.
consistently over several years have not been. But again, you know, you never know.
It's like once.
One case could train all, I guess, right? Yeah.
Yep. But, so that's the risk.
But we also have
some contingency.
We have a better, more consistent. I don't say better, more consistent.
Overview
of how we're giving out. I mean, when it was, catch a select board member, whoever was available,
right.
You know, there was no, I mean, it was, this is much more standard, so.
Since Carolina's come on board, we have really cut down on the expenditures in this line.
So freaking, yeah.
So we can try at 20 and think about it and see if we're okay with that. You know, the next time we look at it. Do you want to do that?
Sure.
So we can just reduce this.
And we're reaching out to more resources too.
Yeah.
Yep. All of those things
we have between
help.
The share fund and vets count and.
Yeah. I'll just make this 10.
Now we're on to SOS to do it too.
And.
So. It's the drug rehab.
The Haven Hill folks?
No, it's a whole other group over by my house.
Oh, okay. That would be Triangle Club, or is it?
Further
same
down.
People? Oh.
Now on the corner where.
Okay.
It's on Central Ave.
Keep popping up.
Triangle Club is still there. They got bigger.
Yeah, so they put an addition on it.
And then SOS is down the road as well.
All right, so I just made some small changes in food and utilities and a big change.
To get us to
20. Okay, summer rec. What happened to the changes I put in?
We're blowing up that budget.
Oh, this is quarter three. Oh, I'm sorry, that's why.
Oh, you made the changes in quarter
yes,
three.
Yes, yeah, that's garbage now, but.
So. Well, can you go back and undo that? You can go back and undo the changes.
I just don't want to take the time right now. So, this is. We're reducing this to what? I don't remember what we were doing.
You
10.
Put that at 10.
No, yeah.
And the food was
7.50.
Oh,
I made it 10. I made
yeah,
it 10.
You made 10.
Made it 10. Thank you.
And then food was 7.50. No, this.
Yeah, and this was.
Yeah, and reduced
3, 2,
by, 15. Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Sorry.
Yeah, well, I've got it as a PDF, so anybody really wants that. All right, we'll wait for Joe. Yeah, it's all covered by revenue, though. Don't get too excited.
Yeah. Still.
And that's why you can't just look at the expense appropriation. You have to understand what's happening with revenue, what's happening with your capital improvement asks. So it's complicated. It's not just one term, one piece.
Yeah.
It all works together. But notice I've simplified it. They're keeping their level of detail, just as the library keeps its level of detail.
Right. It doesn't necessarily be a function of our plan, I guess.
Sorry. No worries. I've just started to talk to Michael about this. So we got the budgets this week, and what I've chosen to do is just put, just like we do for the library and the cemetery, I've got the totals. So summer rec day camp is 42,400. Summer rec team camp, which is new, is 35,065. These items are both covered by revenue on the revenue side.
Correct. And I put a new contingency line in both.
Fireworks, also, I think also covered by their, all of this.
Actually, that's town money. We donate to Denise's.
No, I understand, but it's not covered by the rec. I think the rec committee had a revenue neutral thing.
Yeah, but it didn't include Family Fun Day.
It was on the.
It's part of
that spreadsheet you sent or whatever it was, but it says clearly that it's coming to town.
Yeah.
That
okay.
Wasn't that they weren't responsible for it, but they They just had it all show up.
I just want to...
Yeah, I put by town.
Oh, okay. Can I just bring it up?
Absolutely. I was very fine.
Let me pull it up. No, it's not that.
It's the brownish, reddish color. That's...
Yeah, it's not there.
Yeah, it's here. You can't read this brown thing.
Yeah,
Family Day fireworks, income by town.
Oh, yeah.
Family Day Thanksgiving parade. Well, there's nothing there.
Right.
And then program by town. Okay. So that's fine. So these are otherwise the income and expense are pretty much equal.
Did you guys saw my spreadsheet about the teen camp, right?
Yeah, I did. There's different activities and like the water country passes, that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
You're going to explain that all to us another time, right?
Sure.
Okay.
Whenever you want to hear about it.
All right. I do, but this is the cost, the expense cost for the Camp Raleigh.
Yep.
The teen camp.
Yep, we haven't named it yet.
Family Day fireworks and winter basketball.
And I have not heard back about winter basketball. They had their first meeting this week.
Okay. Winter rec, you know, the skating rink and basketball. So that's a budget of $79,000. All but this $1,600 is covered by revenue.
Oh, and the senior program you got to add in.
What?
The senior program?
They wanted to start a senior program for $300. First, they want to do a survey to see if they want to.
It was part of the, wasn't that part of the spreadsheet?
I guess I get right
on the bottom there. There's that senior program. It's hard to see with that brownish color. But.
All right, so this is entirely covered by revenue.
Yep.
This is entirely covered by revenue. This is covered by revenue. Family Day fireworks, not. Thanksgiving parade, not, but we're not doing anything. Winter rec, not. Senior program. Okay, so.
Actually, winter rec may be revenue neutral if we charge.
You mean for basketball?
Right.
Okay.
Not charge for basketball, no.
They weren't, no.
Don't they travel for buses and things like that for games?
No, apparently they bring the kids by parent.
Oh.
And I'm like, is that allowed? Apparently at the younger ages it is.
Oh, you know, like they carpool, like,
yeah. Because I'm like, oh, it's a town event, you know. Don't you have to take the bus?
Oh, we didn't even know it was a town event.
Yeah.
Until last year, I thought we were assuming it was the school.
Right.
Okay, glad you pointed that out. I just didn't see it. I'm going to call this just whatever it is, family fun day.
Yeah.
You know, rather than fireworks. The library, I don't think we've received their budget, but I think I asked Sarah, and so I put a 3% increase. Well, that's what she said it was coming in as.
Oh, okay.
So I realized. Yeah, see
that. Right.
Patriotic purposes, no changes to that piece.
Is that where her banners and stuff will come in along with the flags?
It will. We don't have it budgeted. We did have it budgeted for 1 year, but
much of the flags.
Nobody used it, so.
The flags were over $1,000, the little flags.
Yeah, right.
Kate wanted new bunting.
Yeah, the new bunting is, you know, we'll have to come on a town hall supplies or maintenance.
Because that was like $400.
Okay. So the flags are now the patriotic purposes?
Patriotic purposes is what the Legion cost share. You know, they do some, we do some.
You know, I get that.
The flags on the poles.
Here, not the ones for the graves.
Now I don't know the answer to that question. I thought maybe it's...
I thought it was just the graves, to be honest. It doesn't, okay. So
it's the same thing. Whatever it is, it hasn't changed.
So we can do away with one of the, my point is you can do away with either 269 or 270 if they're the same thing. Probably 270.
Well, we're not doing anything for one of these lines and haven't all along.
Okay, now I'm confused.
Right? Look at this line. Flags Legion.
Right.
So.
But we have in the past.
we haven't had any change in our behavior. What, why we have these two lines, I don't know the answer to that question.
That's because they're the same thing, aren't they?
We have not, in the time that I have served on the board, done anything other than what we do. Whether it gets charged here or here, you know, this is one of these confusing things about the budget. I've chosen not to worry about this one.
Not worry about it.
Other places, I said, let's consolidate, I haven't, you know.
I thought we could just do away with the line then, but, okay.
Looks like we can, and just call it patriotic purposes.
If that's where it's going to, but maybe not, so if we don't know the answer, maybe we shouldn't do it then.
I just, you know, the next time you may see it, it may not be here, and you'll forget.
I'll be fine with it, I'll be happy. Plus four ignorance.
Yes. Okay, capital projects. So these are all just the ones that we've done in the past, they're there because we've had activity.
Right.
So road reconstruction is $250,000, plus the $75,000 that's up in maintenance, so it's, you know, $325,000. $50,000 of it comes from the DOT, so it's on the revenue side. This is standard and appraisal. Capital projects placeholder, because I don't have a report from the CIP, so I've looked at the CIP.
You've made adjustments, we haven't finished yet, so can't make some adjustments.
Yep, I've been barreling because time doesn't stand still.
Okay.
So I've got the cruiser for $47,500, a mowing attachment for $25,000, side paving for $50,000, which this board member will not support when it comes back to us.
Okay.
Now, that doesn't mean that the board can have its own thing. I think this is the cost. The cost is going to be a lot more.
Yeah.
And I don't see it as a priority item.
Well, you notice that we haven't actually approved the, or made a recommendation to send back to the select board.
No, I understand. I understand. But I have to.
This is just what they gave us.
We have to build something.
Right.
I've got to do something.
But what I'm saying,
I understand.
The CIP committee as a whole hasn't even discussed whether or not we think it's appropriate. It's just been presented to us.
I understand.
Okay.
And we're late in the game, so now I have to deal with how I'm going to do with it. So this is how I've done with it, and I'm just saying, if it's helpful to the CIP, this board member is not going to support whatever this number is. It's going to be more than 15 for as a priority for going forward. And I would like to see it moved on the CIP to be even later, which is where it was. It was like 2023 or something like that. I put the GMC replacement here. Again, just because of what I've heard from George and Jody. So you can see how it works out on the CIP when we get there.
Okay.
And what about wasn't there a plow truck from the fire department they wanted this year? Was that this year or next year?
No, there's the forestry truck
that
can be replaced, yeah.
And doesn't that have a plow on it?
It can have a plow on it, yes.
Why don't we put a plow on?
They plow it up.
Plow the parking lot and stuff like
that. Then why would the town plow the parking lot?
If they're,
Because they do it.
They may do their own right now, but there's also, they need to get someplace, I guess.
The question is, so they could be going somewhere and need to plow something.
That could happen too.
Okay.
Again,
does it have, so it has a plow?
I believe.
The forestry, I think there's another.
If it doesn't have a plow, then I would question why a new one needs a plow, but.
I don't remember that being part of the conversation, but.
And I didn't watch the video, so I don't know if they wanted it this year or just.
It was the forestry truck, but it was a separate conversation. There's structural issues with the truck. It was it's not a commercial vehicle. Apparently it was a former road agent's truck, like personal vehicle, that was sold to the town at whatever cost, and then retrofitted to be a commercial vehicle for the town, for fire service. So it gets used in a way that the manufacturer certainly didn't design it to be used for. That's probably the best way I could describe it.
So anyway,
I don't remember ever a plow being part of the conversation.
Yeah,
I'm
just surprised by that. So this is the placeholder, and this is how I calculated the placeholder.
Okay.
Okay.
This is our financing. As best as I know, this is pretty much known, so this is correct for the bond bank. This is still an approximation. We haven't fully closed. So that's the financing total.
And we had, as a placeholder, had 100,000, right?
We had 110, I think, in our 10-year projection. So we are, we have much less debt service burden than we were projecting. So that's a good thing.
Yes.
And you'll see it on the 10-year projection as well. So this is based on what I think the capital improvement plan looks like now, what we need to ask for next, you know, for reserve funds.
Okay.
Culvert reserve fund, I'm suggesting 10,000, just to continue to rebuild for Sligo Road culverts.
Yeah, and you know, we've been sort of punting on Sligo Road, but I was down there last week before I picked up our CSA, and I came in from Pinch Hillside and went over it. You can see the different sag in the road before and after the culverts. So it may become more pressing than we thought. So
this is a Warren article.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Let's put it to 50.
What?
50.
All right. Because.
What's in our fund now?
Nothing.
Yeah.
We pretty much spent it out with the
the
culvert project. So there isn't anything there.
Yeah. They've just been my nuisance since I got here, so.
I'm sorry?
It's been my nuisance since I got here. If you're not gonna let me put like my March emergency fund line, then this is it. There always seems to have something happen right after town meeting. And I don't get an April emergency line.
That's right, we have to manage.
The joys of municipal budgeting.
How about 20?
Juggling.
All right. It's not like my hesitation, it isn't that I don't think it's prudent. It's just, you know, we don't know when we're gonna need it. It has an impact on the tax rate, you know, a real impact. So, but let's see where we are with what we've done just now.
Okay.
I can do it right this very moment, as a matter of fact.
When did we save the bids for the station or two? Sometime in November, right?
Yes. We have nothing in here for any of that.
Remind us that.
We're not committed. We're not committed to act on it, but yes, we.
No, I understand that. Just if there is a desire, then.
Exactly. That's nowhere in any of this. Good point, Michael. What was I doing?
Spending more money than Jody. Spending 10,000. Yes, for sure. If we do it.
I just don't want to have to own anything else.
No, I can't. I get you.
So we brought it down to 119.
Wasn't it at 105?
No, I thought it was more. I thought it was more than this.
I thought it was 105. You said we need to find.
Well, then we're up.
We went up.
We went up.
No,
congratulations.
We didn't decrease, it was 105.
Okay. Well, that's gone up. That's where it stands now.
Okay. Because it was 2 something, and you reduced the.
120,000 for the tax burden.
You reduced the. Fund balance.
That was done here.
No, I understand that. So, and then you showed us it was 105 and it's a change. So we've definitely gone up.
Oh, okay. All right. So it's gone up.
Yeah.
All right.
Because the impact on the estimated impact on the tax rate was 0.38 something.
Oh, okay. So we've gone up. All right. I forgot. All right. So let's.
Our goal this morning was to find places.
So let's look at the capital improvement plan.
We could cut. So.
Yeah. Congratulations.
We've now,
yeah.
We've now
nice
increased.
Work.
So.
Yeah. Nice work.
How did that happen?
You can ponder that when we leave. Here's the capital improvement plan.
Yeah.
Maybe we should just go to the 10-year projections. Let's go to the 10-year projections. So what we have is an operating budget that goes up 2% for every subsequent year. So this figure is is more than 2% of this, because this is the actual current operating budget. So I, let me adjust it based on what we just did. This is, you know, everything is sort of tied together. So we actually decreased the operating budget a little bit. This is our long-term loan financing. This is what we're asking for CIP, knowing that the CIP hasn't finished its work. This is the total, just so that we have a picture of our road maintenance. I'm taking away 75 because some of it is in the operating budget.
Okay.
This is what I mean. It just gets crazy to have this thing all over the place.
Another 50 from DOT.
50 from DOT. So this is...
So your request for the CIP may be closer to what actually gets recommended, because we don't have anything, any input on highway or transfer at the moment, because George isn't coming in until Thursday, so it may be very accurate. So.
Well, I'll show you how it, what I did. So anyway, we're looking at a... Now, this doesn't include the revenue, because I haven't had time to think about that, how best to bring it in.
Right.
So on the expense side, it's an 8.7% increase.
Right.
And then going forward, I've got 2% increase in the operating budget. This is the actual figure with an uncertainty on the culvert.
USDA.
Yeah. This is, you know, what the CIP is telling us, and I'll show you the changes that I've made, which I will pass along to the CIP. This is annual road maintenance. It's not reflected yet in our 10-year road plan because we didn't update it.
Right.
But Chris Matheson, when he said, you know, for town your size, you should be budgeting 350 to 400,000. So I said, okay, well, we're not going to, you know, fine. Let's try 300. So we've got the 325 this year, and I've got 300 budgeted for subsequent years, and we'll see what happens.
Right.
I've had to take away the road maintenance, which drives me nuts. And we don't know that we're getting any supplement. So you can see that, you know, I would love to find a way to decrease this number and to get, and this is largely from the CIP, is to get the stress, some stress in the CIP off of 2019. So what does it look like, and what terrible things have I done in a vacuum?
Oh, terrible.
So, I don't think there's any change to this. This is the town hall boiler. Maybe I moved it to 2019. That's possible. That's possible. The roof, we now have a $60,000 figure from Murphy,
yep.
And he said 5 years, so
okay.
I've got it.
It's 2023.
Yep, 2023.
To
and
do
I've,
it.
Yep, yeah. And I've got, this is how I apportion it.
Okay.
Culvert repair, I'm thinking, let's not put it here. Let's keep it separate. I think it makes me crazy in my mind about, because it doesn't come from the CIP, it comes from its own thing.
Oh, I see.
That's,
okay, yes.
Yeah, so it's
then,
zeroed
yeah.
out.
Yeah.
No. Old Mill Lane Bridge, this is our portion of it. Right, it's which is 20% of the total cost. So I've started it in 2021, and I'm going to find out from...
20%
yes, that's what I mean. That's exactly what I mean for two homes. Yeah.
Well, look, I can't, yeah.
We're not gonna, there's no implication right now. You know, in January, whenever, we can talk about whether we want to have some help in figuring this out, whether it makes sense to do that. Because
right.
even if we're paying 20%, some of us, we're paying some part of that, you know, $1 million above and beyond that. And, you know, when people are else, right? So that's a lot of money. So we should ponder it ourselves. So that's how I did that Old Mill Lane, which we got from DOT just this year. Town administration was asked to put $50,000 a year, so I've done that. From the that did come from the CIP notes.
That was Bob, yeah.
Renovate third floor. Go ahead, Mike. Sorry.
No, I think, no, no. I'm trying to remember.
I asked Caroline, is that what you want?
It was just 50 for 1 year, and then you were suggesting having that 50 with the 40 that's in there currently as an offset to a bond, and then going in for the rest to bond the rest. It wasn't 50 over...
Oh.
It wasn't that.
So I only have 25 in the CIP, did I?
That's what I told him too. I don't know where he was getting 40 from. I think it was an old document.
It could be, you know, because it moves around from year to year depending on what we actually do. So I've got 25 in there, so...
It'd be more like 50, it'd be 75.
So there'd be 75. So this turns to zero, and it would be a bond or something?
That's what he had presented to us.
Well, that helps, that will help 2019 in an amazing way, but... there's no bond projection either, so we'll have to worry about that, I guess, when we get the... Okay, so do you want me to zero this out?
I would.
All right, I can do that.
That might be your bond payment.
It could be, yeah. I mean, it could be, but it shouldn't be...
Yeah, it won't be enough.
It won't be enough. It shouldn't be that. So.
Unless there's grant money, because we borrowed, we're paying... We will have borrowed about $900,000, and we're paying like $80,000. So this will be more.
And so you would assume approximately, let's just say 1.1. That's a good argument. I think you're going to get a little more. Do 1.2.
I mean, I think there will be some honest discussion about all of that.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Happens.
I think that's one of the projections. I think that was the highest projection we had, so let's just say worst case scenario.
So you've had, so that action did decrease the stress on 2019, but it still is a little high only because, you know, this is so high.
Right.
But that was helpful. There's no doubt that was helpful. Thank you. There's nothing for third floor. That's just kind of there. So I was asked to increase the police vehicle to 25 a year. Is that?
That was for
1 year.
So what Bob was saying, what he would like to do, it could have been over 2 years. Because a number of years ago, one of the cruisers was involved in an accident. The select board at the time would not allow him to purchase a new vehicle. So that they were left with
we skipped
two
a year.
Vehicles.
We said that.
So
we skipped a year.
We have two vehicles currently that have really high mileage on them. So what he would like to do is for two vehicles, and I think it was for 2 years, but I have to go back and look at my notes, was to lease and then go back. So that all the vehicles, when it comes to, will be equalized again. So when it comes time to rotate, you won't have one vehicle with 170,000 and one with whatever. I don't remember the numbers he told us, but.
Well, that explains. I couldn't see why this jump had gone up in the per car cost. Well, the CIP will have to. This is what I have right now because I asked Caroline, "What is that? What do you mean? The 25? Is that every year?" And she thought, "Yes." So that's what I did, with still a purchase every other year. So if there's some way, again, I would love to remove stress from the CIP this year and next year.
I will go back to I will.
Okay, so this is the radar message board mobile sign.
Yeah.
So it's 25,000, half of it's gonna come from a grant.
Yeah.
So I've got 12,005 in 2019, and then I've got other sources.
Yes.
Right? This is a digital fingerprint system, which I have for 2020.
Yep.
So again, if we can maybe move it to 2021, that would reduce the stress in 2020.
Yeah.
Oh no, it's not so much, it's 2019.
2019.
Sorry. We don't have any cost yet for this. Are we not going to have to buy a fire engine in the next 10 years?
We will.
In my humble opinion, yes, we should start planning for it. The committee as a whole, majority of the committee, I don't want to speak for every single member, but the majority of the committee raised some concerns with the priorities as laid out by the fire chief and deputy fire chief, they're both here. That's why we're asking them to come back on Thursday. We want to review again.
Is that this Thursday?
Coming Thursday is the 2nd of November. Things like that you've already brought up, Suzanne, the paving of the parking lot. Is that truly a priority over the air filling station?
Yes.
A number of things, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so I suggested, look, why don't we have him come back? He had just come back from a funeral, from the chief over in South Lake.
Oh, yeah.
So they're all in their dress uniform. They had just come back from that. So why don't we have another conversation with him? I had to assume there was some stress, you know, that they were both for that under, coming from that situation, right? So let's talk to them again and see if those are really priorities, or can we move things around? We want to have another conversation, basically. Because we're not convinced that that the way they have the priorities laid out for this year and next year are really, and we, there was nothing,
there's nothing
for that, so we want to have that conversation.
And the forestry vehicle, I mean, this is like its first hello, we're just finding out about this, so now it has to, we have to do this right away.
I don't disagree with this.
So that's just another, right, so okay, so you'll have a, that's the way it currently looks right now, okay?
But the paving, was it scheduled for 18, or did they just ask for that?
Yeah, they just asked for it. It was 2025. So that puts a stressor on 2018, and believe me, it's not going to be 15,000.
No,
so it's not even close.
His priority, where Suzanne has them listed.
The priority is not, don't look at that. Just
look at
the year.
Purchase year is what I'm talking
about.
The
year really determines.
Yes. That's why we want to talk to him about it. Parking lot really the number one priority that you have?
And paving the front ramp in 2019.
Yeah.
But it's the same comment. I don't think this is enough. And
it's not. We already told him that. We know it's not.
So
that's why we're having
to please get it out in 2019. that's
why we asked for to have. Well, I was thinking Pike at first, but then you suggested maybe George.
We just
more
are looking for, you know,
maybe
without
the
ballpark. Just the ballpark.
Yeah.
Oops.
Like I said, they had just come back, and I know they've been thinking about this ahead of time, but we want to talk about this.
You
went halfway there. I thought you'd want to finish the job. So.
Thank you. Oh, Lord.
He's feeling better. I didn't notice.
There we go. All right. So, those are my concerns with this one, with those two paving things that are coming up soon.
So,
this is what I'm. All right. So, here we go. So, roadside mowing attachment. So,
there's a
five. So, with 20,000 already in the CIP, this is the truck. The truck we didn't buy.
Oh. Okay.
So how about that neat trick, huh?
Okay.
All right. Now.
But okay. Like,
I listened to Jody and George about the GMC.
Okay.
And it had 160,000. George says that's, you know, probably not going to work. So there's 190, with 73,000. Coming from 2018, and the rest is in the CIP.
Okay.
All right. So, now, this is the utility.
So, you're suggesting that next year we're going to buy the...
Well, only because...
We're moving it up from, we have it, or no?
2020.
Okay.
Because if we, so it's going to go through one winter.
Yeah.
If it gets approved, if we don't approve it until 2019, do you know what I mean? It gets, there's another you know, there's another winter. So that's just a, you know, this is what I'm presenting to the board.
Is this what George is going to present to us on Thursday night?
I don't know. No, okay. Not necessarily.
Okay, I thought you worked with him on it.
Well,
he's probably going to tell you sooner rather than later.
Okay.
In that kind of generic way.
Right. And he can tell you more because he'll probably be getting more information back from the inspections.
Yeah, okay.
So, but what I'm saying is that, you know, whatever the placeholder was in our operating budget, this $182,000,
mm-hmm.
so that... For 73 of it is to fund this.
Okay.
So I've got the truck back in there. So it's with 20 at 42,000.
Okay.
And I guess I found 20,000 somewhere else. There was stuff in the transfer station that we didn't use because we came from the the long term loan.
Yeah.
Or a grant.
So this truck is like a 250 instead of the 150 they had recommended last year. And then it would have a utility body on it so they can carry around their equipment with them. And he'll explain all that.
So would I prefer that this be in 2020? Yeah, because again, we're trying to remove some stress from...
So the idea originally was just sort of a little runaround
hang
up, truck.
Yes, exactly.
So they can run for parts and things like
yes.
that. Not necessarily
something else. George can tell you why.
I'm willing to listen. It's a completely different.
It is completely
scenario.
Different. Yes.
And
yes.
then this truck would have a plow on it as well.
Okay. So it already has 20,000 in its little thing, which we can move around. I mean, those aren't commitments, by the way. Just saying, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's right now.
And he may have a different. What he would rather see first, the utility truck or the GMC. And he'll know better, like I said, when he gets...
So Bobcat, we haven't changed this. This is the way it was.
Mm-hmm.
And so he, again, it has 11,000 already there. And there are two more $11,000.
And we were anticipating 2020 when we were going to
yes.
buy.
Yes, yeah. So that's, and so this one may be one with a track, you know, based on... things like that. I don't think this was 190. I made it 190 because I figured if that's the size of that kind of, right?
We told you to increase it.
Oh, okay, you did. Okay, thank God. It wasn't just me.
No.
This is the 1 ton, or whatever we're calling it. It's not a GMC. It's a Ford. What is its name now?
It's a Ford.
Ford
550.
It's currently at 70,000.
And that's in 2026?
Yes, but I think we, last year, maybe I moved it back. Maybe I changed it because we didn't get the truck. You know, this was supposed to reduce the stress on this truck, the utility truck.
Right.
We didn't get it, so we're still using it. So I don't know what an appropriate year is at this point, but it's right now 2026.
Well, the stress, I think, the real stress, I think, got put on that vehicle is in the plow.
Well, I meant, yeah, but if you're putting,
gas, but
yeah, well, but you're
smaller,
driving it.
Yeah.
You're driving it, right? So
yeah,
you're using
driving to
Concord.
Wherever we're going. Concord is a lot different than plowing
the village. Yeah. That's how currently it sits. Now, Jeff, what? If you recall, would talk to us about the furnace, boiler, whatever it is, the heating system. That he said was under whatever. George looked at it and said, I'm not so sure.
Yeah.
So he says, let me live through it. Let me live for a year. So 20 was sort of the placeholder for replacing it. I've now changed the target year to, I haven't changed the target year, but there's no money. I put the 20,000 in future years because this is really unknown.
So it could be 2019.
And it could be
because he wants
2020.
To go to winter, I mean.
It could be 2025.
Right. Okay. Yeah. No.
So.
Sure. For sure.
Because
okay.
it was really kind of unknown.
Yeah.
And certainly I wasn't, you know, if the inhabitants are willing to deal with it, then.
Well, if they say that it really isn't an issue, that it was described, it was previously.
Right, so I think I've got 2019 now is when we would make a decision. But I didn't want to put the money because we don't, that year is really difficult right now. So replacing the roof, this is again a quote from Murphy.
Okay.
And I've got it starting in 2021, and going to 2024. And it may not need to be, he said, you know, so we're going to handle the shingles out of the maintenance in the highway department. He said, you know.
So Murphy said that it doesn't make sense to replace the whole roof just to.
No, he said the roof is, you know, the roof is in good, the shingles are in good shape. They were the wrong shingles and not applied correctly. So it is not, it's practical. It is a practical approach. Just replace the shingles as you need to with a windy storm. That was, you know, that's his recommendation.
They're inappropriate shingles and they were not.
Applied inappropriate.
They were,
there's something called a self-sealing shingle, which they are, I guess, but if you nail them up high, or they're not self-sealing, I don't know. They were nailed up high and
that are not in line.
So at least we have a price, which we didn't have.
Okay, thank you.
Octagon. So a lot of these things went away because we bought stuff with the transfer station project or the grant. So I currently have, this is the 45-yard, you know, so this is a larger municipal solid waste thing. I currently have it for 2019. It's $8,000, which is less than 10. So, you know, maybe it comes out of the operating budget next year.
Yeah, it would.
So, in which case we can get it out of here. So, that's the consideration.
Yeah.
This is replacing the compactor, the old compactor. So, we've got this placeholder of $19,000, and we may not need it in 2027.
Okay.
We don't know. I don't know. And George?
Just for record keeping, do you want to put the new compactor on there? With a zero for now?
Yes.
Sure.
Just so the next
one. I'm just going to highlight this one so I just will take less time for us and I'll take care of it.
Yeah.
Is it still a 4-yard? Is the compact, is that correct? Is that a correct
way? I just call it a compactor.
All right, thank you, I'll do that. There's nothing from any other departments. So that's the year. We need data, that's for the fire engine. And do we want to take this out of the operating budget?
I would say yes.
So that's the way the CIP is right now. I will send this to you so you can use it for the CIP. Is there anything else? Again, the projections. I want to figure out how to manage the revenue piece of it, but this is still, this may not be as bad as it is because we have some extraordinary revenue this year. I have to think about this. I haven't thought about it yet. But I would love to get this number, obviously, down. And I would love to get this number down. I'm not concerned about the others. So that's that. Would you like to look at revenue?
Yes.
A warrant article, Council on Land Use Change Tax Fund, so it sort of self-funded.
Okay.
Resident taxes, no change. Timber tax, no change. Yield tax, we don't do it. I don't even know why it's there. Interest on taxes is good. I don't know. We never get anything charged there. Don't know. Inventory penalties, $10,000. Yep. We've been booking it.
Okay.
What are you looking at?
I'm just looking at 2016.
Well, these are still, these are anticipated, none of these are actuals, these are still...
2016 is an actual?
It could be.
Must be, right?
Yeah, that could be, yeah. Revenue, yeah, it is, it's revenue, it is. So, we've been booking it. Inventory penalties, we've been booking it. Business licenses, right. $600,000 for motor vehicle permits. And Jim added something to the fleet.
Yeah, I was gonna say, Jimmy's buses did a lot more than our cars, I think. We have, Ian's been saying there's been a lot of increase in car sales. Our registration.
So this is what we generated as of the end of quarter three. So it looks like we're gonna meet the six, you know, we're gonna meet the $600,000 this year, so we're close to it.
It has to be my two register. Not that it's $6,000.
Yeah, let's hope not.
We have all December. Yeah, I drive the bus.
So that's helpful. That's a $50,000 increase in revenue. That's a very nice thing. The motor vehicle surcharge, we're anticipating $5,000 more than this $20,000 because we started this really late.
Yeah. You know, we don't have 4 years for it.
We're not going to make this $15,000 this year because we started really late. We didn't start until June, and this was based on an April start date.
Yeah.
But there were setup issues with the state and so on. But we should be able to get the full $20,000 next year. Building permits, I decreased it.
I think that's the problem.
You know, Chinburg activity is slowing down.
Yeah.
Other license permits, I don't know why it's less, but it comes out less. Maybe I didn't change this.
Permit. Yeah, I was going to say, we should ask Bob if that's going to go away or not.
Oh, yeah, that would.
So
I think they can still issue them though, if people want them. They're just not required to have one. And that's what we've been asking,
okay,
if people are actually coming in for asking for them. So if you're going to go to another state,
yeah, oh,
you still,
yeah,
have one, because there's reciprocity between.
Yes, it is.
Between.
So I think based on how we've been collecting revenue this year, I reduced the alarm permits to this, and I reduced just the general other to this. I didn't touch the custom permits. So that gives us an overall reduction of $1,000 in revenue for that bond. State room and meals, there's a reduction. I finally got through to Michelle this week about, so this is the figure.
We're losing $48.
Yeah, but we're gaining $3. I says, oh, Michelle, I'm so disappointed. This is usually, yay. Because usually there have been increases, and there wasn't.
Is it $3 Oak Street? Well, you know, I mean, it's a flip joke, but we should, hopefully the state knows that we should be getting part of, I don't know how to...
Yeah, we have to be careful because we don't know what the main, you know...
The bridge.
The state does the bridge.
Bridge.
The state was there, by the way, this week, yesterday.
Yeah.
Did you know that?
I
was heading towards Central Avenue, and there was one lane traffic on the bridge.
Oh, yeah.
I thought they were doing some repair work on the deck, and they may have been, but then I saw them also working on the side, the metal sides.
Because as I recall, memory can be a tricky thing sometimes, the state had it, but they weren't going to put that traditional wooden deck back on, and Dover said, oh no, we have to have it. And so the state said, okay, fine, Dover, you're paying for the wooden deck, then we're not doing it. So you're probably right that they still...
This was the state.
The,
I just know, oh, okay, because I thought, well, maybe it's Dover, because I heard that Dover was taking it over. But
you see the giant tire and bridge from heavy trucks that shouldn't have gone over it, so...
So this is the $50,000 revenue for the state supplemental grant. Which we may decide to cut into if there's this, I haven't heard from Chris about Kelwyn. We may not, we may choose not to, I don't know. But right now, the full 50, whatever this is, not quite 50, is going to be revenue next year. This is our railroad tax revenue for the DRA. Income from departments is up. So, here's the, we don't know, we don't have anything from the library, so that's why it's yellow. Yes, because they're covering, yep, so this is what I mean. So their expense is being covered on this side. So when you look at the total percentage increase in the expense side, you have to be careful because some of it is covered by legitimate increases in revenue, so it's not that full 8%. I just have to think about how better to describe it.
So we have another potential revenue source, I think, as part of the plan to help offset the cost of all day full day kindergarten. This past year, it was proposed and mm-hmm. enacted that towns can put on their own yearly norms, or whatever cities in the city like it, whether or not they want to allow Keno to be implemented in their community. And the only place that it could happen in Rollinsford, I think, is the that example, it has to be done in the restaurant. Maybe bars too, but we don't have any.
Well, I figured a little more.
Actually. So we should be thinking. I don't know though what
I thought the school was.
Yeah, but there is a I don't know. I'm not articulating at all. I'm just sort of stumbling now. There is a revenue sharing, I think, with the municipality that allows it. Now maybe it is, does go to the school, but you know, it all comes out of our left pocket, our right pocket,
right.
So, but we should be thinking about that. We are the people, though, that would be saying, "Do we want to put it on the ballot?" Not the school.
Not the school.
So we should be thinking about that, because that could be potential revenue into the town. Mm-hmm. Maybe not on our side, but on the school side.
Let's just.
That would be a lot. I have no idea, but we should be thinking about it. Now, the voters could also say, "Absolutely not." You know, we don't want to have gambling happening in town, even though it's already happening.
Right.
And go and like the corner store for scratch tickets and things, but you know.
Is that being spoken?
I have no idea.
Close enough.
I think so. Uh-huh. I've never done it. Uh-huh.
All right, that's just there. Okay, so we were in departments. So this is the recreation committee. Zoning books, no need to, you know, increase that because we're hoping that they get it online. Copying,
yeah.
Incidental, RFD reports. Outside detail, this is not incidental. Mm-hmm. So I took the 60% we put on the expense side and did, you know, 1.5 times to get there. Because he said it's about 50% more that you get on the revenue when you budget. So if they really think they're going to bring in 75, that makes this number big, you know, it's, the number is bigger in the expense side, but it's even bigger here. But he had some reluctance. He talked things over and said, I think 75 might be too high. So I'd rather get a Christmas bonus than
right.
a disappointment.
Correct.
So parking fines, there's no real change any of this. This is pending the rate increase that we are proposing. Cardboard recycling, scrap metal, pretty much just in line. Transfer fees of the various tipping fees that we ask people to pay,
right.
And demo fees. Different, I don't know, but different. So I guess these are for refrigerators, these are tires.
Batteries.
Yeah. So I was just doing some analysis.
And are we, when you were all looking at the increase to the sticker for the transfer station, have we reviewed the fee structure to make sure we're actually making and to meet, we're actually covering the actual cost?
No, we're still, you know, but we've gone from like, I don't know where I did that. We will go from like 32% to maybe 40%.
No, but what I mean, so if it costs $10 to dispose of a tire, and we're only charging
the
six.
Fees?
Yeah.
I don't know, somebody, maybe George can look at the fees in neighboring states.
We've been,
like
what
Dover,
we've been,
Somers,
well, no, what we've been, the fee's supposed to cover the actual cost, right? So, and the administrative costs, so if we're...
Right, but I mean, if you look at another town, I mean, that would shoot.
We looked at our numbers this year, and they're comparable with Barrington and Lee. And
they are? Okay, we've already done it. Okay.
Yeah.
The only one we had to change was the Freon.
Yeah.
We had to up the Freon because air conditioners.
Air conditioners.
Yeah.
So, but at any point that we want to review that, we can.
Sure, well, I'm just saying, we're looking at now, but you already have, so.
Well, we did this past year. Okay, so that's income for departments, so it's gone up based on the detail work, which we haven't been doing the revenue adequately anyway, so that's kind of where it is. Sale of municipal property, this is going down because we're not really selling anything, so it'd just be cemetery lots, and that's really incidental. Interest on investments, that's still aspirational, I think, but. $500.
Exactly, yes, we made $145 in 2016.
Yeah. So other is up. Where's other? All right, so cable franchise fees no change, cell tower lease no change. This I've sent a letter off to Hydro folks to see if we're still okay budgeting that. Rents on property no change.
Al had mentioned though something the other night when he was here about the Turcotte Field, that's the old lease, right? That perhaps we might want to revisit it and see if it makes sense to increase based on use for like the clearing that we were talking about, the invasive species clearing all around the perimeter of that field. Because it was more intense, I guess, than what they originally thought. I mean, I don't think it's fair to, well, we'd want to, you know, talk to them about it, but. And renegotiate them.
Yeah, I think it's time. It's been this way for a while anyway. I mean, I can highlight it and see if anyone has time to think about it. I mean, I contacted some farmers at the time when we sent this.
Okay, and that was a reasonable rate. Then.
Well, and we have a contract based on a certain number of acres. So if he's actually using more,
I have
with,
no
with
idea.
The additional clearing.
Al just sort of threw it out there as an aside, I think.
I must
Monday
have been,
night, so.
Yeah, I must have been thinking about something else. Based on what he was talking, I don't remember that. I remember he said, what I do remember is he said that they would be doing some additional clearing that they would be covering from their.
Yeah, and then he said, well, if you have that lease, perhaps it would make sense to have that the person paying the lease to pay part of that increased rent or something like that.
I missed that, so. Yeah. Bank fees, that's here, I'll get to it in a minute. So I reduced it to zero, we just get rid of the line, I think. Disbursement for Lamprey Regional. We don't have that this year. That was last year, the $1,000 they gave us.
It was more than $1,000. It was like $1,500.
I think we didn't know when we did the budget, right?
So
if we got 15, it's there. This is just what we were anticipating.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So,
I don't know if you needed how actual we needed that.
The actuals will come in when Caroline does the report. And then FEMA Homeland Security, this is the what we have budgeted on the expense side, and this is the revenue when we get reimbursed for either FEMA, Homeland, or whatever, all of the grants that come in for those kinds of things. And so the line under executive for miscellaneous reimbursements is $14,700, so we need to do the reimbursement, so we need to do that here. Banks, the bank fees have been rolled into that, so that's why we don't have that budget. Okay, so let's go back. That's other. This is the placeholder for capital reserve funds. So these are expenditures for the attachment, the whatever else that we'll reimburse from the CIP. Okay. This is the cemetery trust fund. You know, at some point they're supposed to be giving us money, I think. If they haven't been because the principal is, but at some point they will. So. Land Conservation Fund, this is a standard warrant article.
Mm-hmm.
Grants, so this is our DARA grant that's gonna come in, we didn't anticipate it for 2017 because it only happened after town meeting, and we're not gonna get it in 2017, it's actually gonna come in 2018, so here it is.
Yeah.
Then this is the Department of Safety grant that Bob mentioned to us the other night, so I added that, so that's what this is. Library, it now is included in income from department, so we could just get rid of the slide. We don't have any history at the moment.
Okay.
Now, and this is fund balance. We've been sort of I think we actually did 230 last year because of the, so we got some surprises.
Right.
But we've been anticipating or planning to use 200. I'm recommending that we plan to use just 100 because of this, to offset the grant so that we're not thinking that we have more money than we actually have to play with, just so we have some money. And so that gets us to, unless we've made any changes, that gets us to here. Back here where we didn't make any improvements, but we're thinking about some things, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's where kind of this is. When can we meet again? Can we do it next Saturday, you think? Is that possible?
Pardon says no, I think I already have something for that. Four, right?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, I agree with you.
You can see AM?
Yes, I can. I'm available.
I am, but you're gonna have to tell Scott. Nine AM again?
Yes.
Okay.
11:04, 9 o'clock.
Luckily, the kids are old enough.
I think that we won't. This is the first time the three of us have kind of looked at it all together, and there are a bunch of new things like the highway and this and that. So maybe next time.
And is this after you meet with George and the fire again?
Yep.
Good.
Yeah. We'll be doing that on the second. So.
So hopefully, I'll get a report from Caroline. Usually gives me the report from that committee that I can put into the spreadsheet for next Saturday.
And next Thursday, we do our interviews for the road agent.
So that we have several more coming in the last.
I think one of them said, the answer to the question, do you have a CDL? The answer was no, so I thought that was interesting.
So that one. But all the others have said yes, right?
I think so. There was just one.
Good.
I think there were various levels. I don't understand the levels myself, although there's an A and B, I guess.
Yeah,
A,
but the,
which is the better?
The one came in yesterday. It's at 5 o'clock. So.
All right, so next meeting at 9?
Yes.
Okay, we're done.
So we're not meeting on Monday evening?
Correct. Your trick-or-treating, so have a wonderful time with your respective children.
Oh, what's the name there? Preps said fine. So your plan to move money around?
Oh, for this year?
It should be fine.
17, thank you. Good.
Good, that's good.
I
said we wouldn't take any entire amount, but you said we thought that.
Okay.
See if there's more.
Excellent. Thank you for checking.
All right,
good.
Well, I'm going to talk to
you. I need to check.